Hello. Hi, Devil Gay.
Ooh.
Pray. Thank you so much for the 20 months. Shane, thank you for the 4. Wraith, thank you so much for the 60 fucking 2. There's so many weird ass fucking Twitch babies we have now. I don't know how, I can't maths right now. Wait, how many? Alexa, 62 divided by 9.
62 divided by 9 is approximately 6.8889.
We have 6 babies together. That is weird. Hello, good morning, good evening, good afternoon, ladies, lads, wonderful fuckers in between. Jake. 62 months. 62 months. There's like 6 babies, apparently. How are you today? I'm doing good. Hi, Baba. Hi, Prey. Hi, Pango. Hi, hi. How is everyone doing? How's everyone's week? Sorry I didn't stream yesterday. I kind of got a new phone. I might need to turn the volume down. Shush, my gen. Okay. Thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Wait, I'm not on the right screens. In the middle of a crisis. Bro, why is that your comparison? Because it's stupid. It's a Twitch thing. You always turn around and you take the sub length and you divide it by 9, and that's how many babies you have had that with that person. They're called Twitch babies. Yeah. The bendy phone. It's not bendy. It's flat out of me. Hi, Sally. Oh, yeah. I got rid of the, I should have. I think I did. I should have gotten rid of the boost. Do I sound less boomy compared to before? I should have gotten rid of the, Let me check the filters. I did. I got rid of the gain because I felt like it was just making me super fucking loud and I didn't really like it, so I got rid of it. I should sound a bit cleaner compared to before. I've been painting my grandma's fence today, so I'm tired. Are you using a roller or a brush? Be smart, use a roller, don't use a brush. Way quicker. You can do like 5 panels at the same time. She's making you do it with a brush. Tell her, grandma, this isn't the 1800s anymore. I can do it this way. Let me do it this way, woman. But yeah, thank you everyone for all the subs. Thank you so much for the hype train. I really, really love it. Appreciate it. It looks like the hype train's gonna go bye-bye though. Thank you so much. I really do love it. Appreciate it. You have no idea how much the subs mean to me. It's so warm right now. It's so fucking warm. But yeah, I got a new phone. True, but she's old, so I've got to do it her way. Listen, just because the boomer generation is the most entitled generation doesn't mean they're the right generation, okay? You have modern technology. You have a phone in your pocket, which is more powerful than the fucking spacecraft that got us to the moon. You're allowed to use a fucking roller. OnlyFans was gifted a sub. How? What? Give a fucking gifted sub to like ADC or someone. And give it to OnlyFans. Fuck OnlyFans. They stole $200 from me. Fuck them. Give one to Fansly though. I like Fansly. Fansly likes me. They take care of me. Anyway, good morning, good evening, good afternoon. How was all your week? So what did you guys get up to? I spent my week doing... Onita. Girls still aren't gay? I mean, you're not wrong, Eastman. Thank you so much for gifting the subs. You've got 20 seconds to get another level on the hype train to get it continuing. Otherwise, it... By the time you hear this, it'll be gone. I was wrong. Thank you for giving AD a sub. You can stop now. You can stop now. No! What? Jake, what's wrong? Did you want your level one emo? Or are you the one wanting to be giving the subs, huh? 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 What's wrong? Nice AD got a sub. Yeah, you give on to Glub as well. I need to hang out with them more. I've been shelling myself a bit too much recently. I need to break out of that habit. 17, not an addict at all. Nah, Tay, yeah, you're fine. Thank you for giving OK Kuro a sub. Really appreciate it. I need to get... Do you want to know a really, really good tactic to grow on Twitch? This is apparently a great way to grow on Twitch. What you do is you get really fucking good emotes and then gift them to big creators and hope to fuck they use your emotes because they like them. That is apparently a valid tactic to grow on Twitch. You invest a good amount of money into some fucking god tier emotes, and then you gift sub to big creators and hope that they use them, and then other people will be like, oh my god, who is this sub? You are my waifu for... Like, ooh, I can't believe I'm talking about. Okay, so $40 per emote. Let's go. Really good emotes. Yeah. Hello, Richie. I see you're subless. Apparently, that's a sin in this chat today. We'll be fine, though. I'm pretty sure East Bean's out of bullets to shoot. But how are you doing, Slick? I haven't seen you in a while. I hadn't seen you since last weekend. I kind of had technical issues on Wednesday. Oh my god, stop! Jake! What are you doing? I'm so thankful Taris isn't here. I'm so thankful Taris isn't here right now. I know what Taris is like. Taris very... Or Dunny. I'm so thankful Dunny is not here. I know for a fact Dunny isn't here. Dunny's been fucking... Me and Dunny have been talking a bit. And Dunny spent 2 days this week doing a tattoo. Hi Kerberos, hey, good morning streamer and chat. Good morning sweetheart, how are you doing? I've been busy all week, actually. I spent my week doing like project stuff, big project stuff. The big project stuff gets bigger every time. Like I go near it and I'm like, oh, I should start getting the list shorter. No, the list gets longer. And my to-do list gets bigger, and I'm just looking at it going, yeah, but it looks so cool! I've got to get it bigger, and then the plan is to get it to a point, and then I'm like, okay, I think that's enough, and then we start shrinking it. Also, speaking of AD and being sub, I hit 26 month of being subbed there in 4 days. Nice! Oh, it's a kitty. No! Phil, no! Mm-mm. By the way, I'm running an experiment. I put some chat commands in my chat. I want to test something. Just testing something. But yeah, how are you doing, Phil? I hope you're doing okay. I'm really scared to like touch my overlays right now because it was crashing a bit earlier. I tried to add a GIF in the corner. It just went no. Ain't going to stay for long. I currently am.
Oh my lord, I'm gonna go jerk off into my toilet. Yes!
Oh. Every time.
You're butt cute.
No! Fuck you. Love you, but fuck you. Taris! Welcome to the stream. We missed you. How was your vacation? Huh? How was your vacation? Chat's going crazy. You disappear for like 2 fucking weeks. There's no hype trains. We chillin', we...
Now look, Buster, let's have an understanding.
Okay.
Now what? Brother, what a way to run a railroad.
Onita.
Now, as I was saying...
Oh god. Hello? Hello? Fuck me. I feel you. Calm down. Yeah, you disappear for 2 weeks. There's no hype trains. And then you're not even in the chat. And you turn up and there's fucking hype trains. Terrace, what is it with you and this chat and fucking hype trains? Is the hype train still going? It is. For some reason, Pango decided to pin a message, which supersedes the fucking hype train. I go. I feel like the hype train should take priority. It's so dumb. Hi, Snack. I'm a dork. I'm a dork. I'm a geek. I'm a nerd. I'm a fuck up. And I'm lewd as hell. Yeah, Terrace, I don't know what it is. I think it's because chat loves you so much and they don't want you to not feel, yeah. I didn't know it does that. Yeah, I don't like that it does that. I really don't like that it does that. You would expect it to prioritize that. And then like, oh, we'll just keep it pinned in the background until the hype train goes. I have done so much OBS work over the past 2 weeks, it could be considered a year's worth of work from... Are you just catching up, Terrace? I swear, are you seriously just... You oh my god. You just playing catch up? Terrace, are you just playing catch up right now? Thank you so much for the 25 gifted subs. I don't know what to say or do. Meow. Meow. Thank you so much for the 2500. I really do appreciate it. Yo, level 8. It's a level 8! Oh yeah, I've got it right here. Level 8? What the fuck? What a competition. What a competition. They... Terrace, I swear to fuck, if Dunny was in the chat right now, Terrace and Dunny would be just slogging big dicks around. I know what they're like. Hi, Ocean. Hi. Welcome to the stream. Hi. How are you? How are you? You doing okay? Feels like it's been forever. Hi. Terrace, we missed you. We seriously missed you. I'm so glad you're back. I'm hoping you had a really, really good break. I should actually go into the settings on these screens quickly.
You're cute.
I can't go into the settings, apparently. Fuck. Yeah, it was a lovely and comfy. I'm so happy for you. I got my new phone, by the way. I decided to pull the trigger and just go, you know what, fuck it. If I can find it on a good deal, I'm just going to get the phone. So I got the new phone. I like it. I got a case on the way. I'm liking it. I need to get the iPad, though, but I want to hit the goal first because then I feel confident doing it. And now I'm going to back into the Final Fantasy 14 grind. King, we salute you and love you deeply. Yeah. I love the phone, by the way. I was playing around with the camera on it last night, and I'm like, oh, I like the camera on this. The old phone? Holy shit. You know the whole Aurora Borealis shit, where you had to pull out your phone and point it to the sky and take a picture and then do adjustments to see the Aurora row? My old phone was so shit. I tried it, didn't do fucking anything. But the new phone has a setting for night shooting. And apparently, it is so good, you don't even have to go in and do the adjusty thing. You just take the picture and it goes, yeah. Have you already set it up for desktop shenanigans? Yeah, do you wanna know how quick it was for me to set up for desktop shenanigans? It took me 2 minutes. I shit you not, it took me 2 minutes. It took longer for the software on my PC to load than it took me for me to finish setting up. It was it. It just worked. I see stars. You see stars? Why you see stars? What phone you got? I got the iPhone 15 Pro Max in white. Yeah, I got the 15 Pro Max. Taken any nudies yet? No. No. I might take a picture after I do some makeup practice. I find slick. You know how you see all those VTubers and you wonder, oh my god, how is their face tracking so good? And you see other VTubers and they've got reasonable face tracking and then they're okay. But you see the difference between their face tracking is amazing and their face tracking's okay. The amazing face tracking comes because of the iPhone. The okay face tracking comes from other methods. The reason why is the 3D depth scanner. No, I don't look at them and go, they look amazing. They're good phones, hun. I don't really watch VTubers, but you're a LuTuber. That's completely different. You're a LuTuber. I realized I fall into the trans femme stereotype. Awesome! I feel like I only really started pushing properly with my transition recently. I'm in a different industry now. You're still a LewTuber, hun. I would still classify you as a LewTuber. Booba and booty tracking? Eventually. But yeah, there's nothing wrong with falling into a stereotype when it comes to being trans and feminine. I'm honestly feel like I only just started with my transition. I had the whole bullshit of the psycho X. I've been pushing more with my weight loss. By the way, I lost 5 pounds, all of it on my thighs. I lost all of it on my thighs and like a bit around my waist. I lost 5 pounds in a week. And I have a bum ankle right now because I got a massive fucking blister on it. It sucks. Hi, Olive. Hi, Oliver. Hi. Welcome to the stream. How are you? Imagine boob. My phone is actually the last of its kind because when I purchased it, the company stopped making phone, and also my phone has a radio thing in it, so I can listen to the radio FM when I plug in headphones. I feel like you have a HTC because I too have a HTC. I have an old HTC. It's like EVGA NVIDIA graphics card. Lose thigh fat, gain chest fat. Actually, you're not wrong, Eastbin. I lost about 2 inches off of both of my thighs. So 2 inches, 2 inches, so I lost 2 inches on each of my thighs. I lost 1 inch around my waist, and I gained 1 inch around my titty. But I've been not been able to exercise all week because of like shit going on. I've learned baked potatoes are a no. Baked potatoes are a no. They throw me out of keto and make my life harder. Best to lose gain ratio so far. I'm still, do you know what's really funny? Every week I measure myself. I track my weight. I measure my weight loss. And I do measurements to see, hey, if I haven't lost weight, did I gain muscle and maybe slim down differently? Because sometimes that happens. So I'm tracking those separately. And like, yeah. I'm doing them separately so I can track them easier. And I go into a checker to see what my figure is, and every week it's like, you're an hourglass, and this is your titty size. And I've been a 30, I'm borderlining a 36D now. I'm still a 38D, I'm currently a 38D, but I'm like borderlining a 36. My main issue with losing weight is figuring out meals whilst on a budget. Do you want to know what the best... Okay, Tay, do you want to know the way that I've been doing it? It's a really simple diet called the zigzag diet. Monday to Friday, you hardcore and you eat as little as possible. Don't go stupid. Try and keep yourself above about 700 calories. If you're trying to lose a lot of weight, keep yourself above 700 calories. And then what you do is on the Saturday and the Sunday, you let loose. So Monday to Friday is really, really cheap. Saturday and Sunday is you can just put a bit more in. It should end up costing you way less in the long run. Something to consider. I gotta go now. Have a great stream and love to you all. Have a wonderful day, Slick. I hope you have a great great rest of your week. Oh yeah, congratulations to Flair and getting their fucking Discord account back. I pay no attention to the numbers. I just know I have C and they're good enough for me. Well, the number is the strap underneath. You can have a C cup, but you don't know this if you're a C cup if you don't know the strap size. So this, yeah. Actually, I think, yeah, I'm wearing a 38D right now, and it's loose. I'm probably a 36D, in like a couple of weeks, I'll probably be a 36D, and then like, yeah. Also, I'm really sorry I didn't stream on Wednesday, or the Thursday with the secret stream. I kind of had technical issues on Wednesday, and the constant bug crap with doing those streams is just emotionally fucking annoying me. So yeah, your model has jello physics. Cool. No, it doesn't. It's just titty physics. Bring me. He. Boom! 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 Shit happens, we pick ourselves up and move on. Well, Tay, the thing is now I have a workaround, and that's... Yeah, I have a workaround now, and that's like the thing. I don't like having a workaround, because if the workaround breaks, I'm fucked. And that's the point which I don't like. I need to figure out what the problem is so I can go back to the method that I've been using in the hopes that it doesn't break. What's your favorite snack? What's my go-to snack these days? I like mozzarella cheese. You know, like a bowl of mozzarella cheese that you can get in like a little sachet. I love going for those, but I guess cheese string is my favorite. I think in America, they might call it Kraft string cheese. Okay, is my favorite snack. I'm no food. But yeah, I like I think a mozzarella ball is a really, really good snack because they're decently sized, they're reasonable, and yeah. That is not jello. Jello physics is when you slap it and it wobbles for 2 to 3 minutes without input. Yeah! Mine is a... I just... Whisper Gold is my current go-to snack, but if we're going old school, Toffee Crumble is for me. Katie has IRL inspired physics. Yeah, I'm gonna probably soften them up a bit and make them a bit more wobbly in the future though. I just don't think it needs to be super over the top. Like real life, mine has a little wah-wah in real life. I feel bad because everyone is about losing weight and I've been trying to gain pounds. Snack. There's nothing wrong with wanting to gain weight. If you are of a smaller frame and you've had eating disorders and you're trying to help yourself and gain more weight, there's nothing wrong with wanting to lose weight. But the most common eating disorder in Europe and the Americans is binge eating disorder. Did you know that? Did you know that the most common eating disorder on the planet, it isn't anorexia, it isn't bulimia, it's binge eating disorder. And 9 times out of 10, no diagnosis, no nothing, no problems. Because binge eating disorder just makes someone gain weight. The others who makes them lose weight. And it's way more tragic to lose a ton of weight and then pass on. It's just way more common to become super obese and just fade into nothingness because of your weight. I'm 260 pounds. Officially. Officially, I am 260 pounds. I was, when the psycho bitch was here, 450. So you do the maths. I've lost 190 pounds in 2 years. So, yeah. It takes a lot of effort to lose weight. Yeah. Don't feel bad about it, Snack. You've got this. Best of luck. We believe in you, Snack. I have high burn rate, I eat and eat, and I can't seem to gain weight. I'm borderline underweight. East Bean, I'm assuming you move around and you do a lot. If you want to lower your metabolism and slow things down, don't move around as much. And drink diuretics. I know this sounds really, really bad. It's probably the shittest option you've got. If you want to gain a ton of weight, stop drinking water. Or reduce your water intake and drink things like sugar-free energy drinks or drink loads of sugar-free cola, get cheap cola and just drink loads of that. My major issue is high metabolism and I've been the same weight for 13 years and counting now. I wish to gain pounds to turn that into muscle. Tired of being called skeleton or twig. Depends on what you're eating. If you're eating things like fruit, salads, if you're eating things which are low process and stuff, then that's where you're probably going wrong. You need high carbohydrate, high processed shite to gain a load of weight, in my opinion. It depends though, because you can also go for high fat meats, like pork. Pork is a good one. Chicken isn't great for it, but pork beef, just high fat yielding meats is really, really good. Oh, thank you a lot for the information. Hi, Aiden. Hey, ADMP. Bonjour. Percent of my fluid intake is soda, Monster Energy, and sometimes I sit and not move. Sometimes I'm up and about and move a lot. It really does do any noticeable difference for me. My problem is in the mornings I'm super active, and then I start my work roughly around midday because I work at my PC. And then the reason why I tend to work out in the later evening is to get the blood pumping again, because in the morning I wake up, I go out and I do shit and I do the stuff which I need to do outside. Then I come home and work on whatever I'm working on, and then around 5-6 p.m. I'll go work out, I'll go for a bath and I'll do what I need to do, and then I'll sit down and work again. So about 9 to 10 hours of my day is spent sat down, and the rest of it is either sleeping or walking. So it's not a lot. Looking at bulking guides, bulking food, meals, etc. and stuff, try out, go for stuff you know you can stomach and slowly, yet gradually increase it over time. I eat lots of breads, beef, chicken, venison, pork, turkey, tons of junk food like crisps, pretzels, and jerky. I do eat veggies and not so much fruit. It feels to me, based on what you've said, it feels to me you could be bulking out your meals with vegetables. Try dropping down the vegetable intake. Good option for you. Rice. Go for rice. Particularly short grain rice. If you can find short grain rice, sushi rice, risotto rice, short grain rice in general, really, really, really good for gaining weight, not so much losing weight. Great, it's got good fiber, it's really, really high carb to not ratio, and it'll be really, really worth trying. Just try out, try adding more rice into your diet. Do what I would refer to as the what would I call it? I would call it a Japanese side. Do a Japanese side. So add rice to your food. Just add like a bowl of rice. So eat whatever and add a bowl of rice to it. Because rice has a tendency to take up a lot of your body's food absorption. So when you're eating it, it takes up more of the space. Meaning the good stuff doesn't get as much processing, but then it pushes it into your stomach, and then it's like, ah, now we can process, so it's not going to get as much processed done. And then that's how it works. Yeah, because it absorbs like stomach acid and stuff. The doctor said that I am too skinny, but he did not say what is my weight target. But since I work at my job, I gain a bit of muscle mass, but I don't know how I did that. You could just be moving around a little bit more. It's been like this for years for me. I've been mostly in front of the computer gaming versus years. I'm working and jogging a lot and stuff doesn't really do a difference. You'll be surprised what will eventually make the difference. My top advice for anyone who's trying to lose or gain weight, it's all about the diet. Your weight loss and your weight gain is 80% diet, 20% work, 20% physical. So if your diet is shit, your weight loss is shit. Does that make sense? So get your diet under control. Layer your cake. Layer your fucking cake. Get your diet working for you, and then worry about workout later. That's more for weight loss, though. Veggies are normally only for lunch, as I'm at work for lunchtime and they provide lunchies. Might I suggest you lower your vegetable and your fruit and vegetable intake? You know the whole concept of the 5-a-day thing? The reason why the whole 5 or whatever it is a day now, I think it's like 10 or 15 a day, the reason why they do the whole 5 to 10 a day thing is because there's vitamins and minerals in the 5 a day, which inherently helps your body process food. If you aren't getting your 5 a day, your body's going to get the stuff from other foods, like processed crap, which might not have it. It will have it, but in very small amounts. So it will be absorbing the crap more, along with the stuff it's trying to find. So try to avoid fruit and vegetables and salads and stuff. Just try for like a week. You want your diet, if you're trying to gain weight, make your diet as beige as possible. If it's more than like a brown or a tan, it better be from a steak. Make your meals beige and brown. And the only color you're allowed in your diet is like a good red, pink, like a medium rare steak. Yeah. Depending on the doctor, I'm told to gain weight. Sorry if too much information, but I'm 6'5", 170 to 175 pounds, depending on the day. Delete if too much information. Han, that's not enough. That's fine. You're fine. You're taller than me and you're my goal weight. You're my goal weight for this year, actually. I've got 6 weeks to try and lose 20 or 30 pounds. I gotta try and lose like 20 or 30 pounds before TwitchCon. I'm gonna say 30. 5 pounds a week, roughly. That's what I've been losing with just my diet. So I'm kind of happy. Next week, my goal is to be 158. About 157, 158, give or take. All right behind you, Katie. You're a couch? What? Huh?
For support, honest.
Oh! Oh! I got it. Oh, did you like the video, by the way? Can everyone in the chat right now thank Rafe for the edit they did for the video? I was really, 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 really happy with it. Rafe's been very slowly learning. Rafe's been very slowly learning how to edit longer videos. Yeah, I'm couch, sit on me, please. Not this stream. My job is high movement and even more movement during warm weather, as during warm sessions, I'm groundskeeper, and cold seasons, I'm housekeeper. I'm gonna suggest one thing for you, hun. It's what athletes use to give them energy throughout the day. Rice sandwiches. Go get your... So you know those microwave rice packets you can get at the store? Go find your... Go find a few favorite flavor types. And what you do is this. You microwave one of those bags. And one of those bags should do two sandwiches for you. You do two, maybe three sandwiches. You cut it... You dish it into three sandwiches. And then you just have that. If you want to, you can add like a protein. You can do something like that. Rice sandwiches. Favorite rice. I recommend the katsu curry rice. I fucking love that shit. But they do peri peri. You can do different flavors like every day. Are the bags edible? No. You can't eat the bags. They're made of plastic and they're microwavable. But yeah. Snack. Try rice sandwiches and you can just change the rice. Oh, I'm so itchy. Oh my god. I will only recommend rice sandwiches to people who are trying to gain weight. But they are great for energy. They're what athletes use to give themselves energy for long periods of time when they're like doing runs or sports. And if you're trying to do it and you're not trying to up your physical activity, fucking night and day difference. Trust me, massive fucking night and day difference. Go shower. I will go bath after stream. Don't tell me you're going to swim. I have ice cream, by the way. I worked out that the store doesn't do the Bailey's one. So I'm sad. I'll get some Bailey's stuff next week. But I got ice cream. I've heard it's bikini weather. I know, I'm working my ass off for it. Also, hi Dakota. Hi. Hi, Kara. How are you doing? Shower stream? No, I'm not doing a shower stream. I'm not going to do a shower stream.
Didn't lose your self-control when it starts on the radio.
I love how the fucking... song from Cyberpunk that made everyone fucking cry basically became a top hit. I jokingly said at work that I'm trying to get swole for when I get back to housekeeping role. Kind of hope I can put on enough to get some muscle mass. Snack, I'm not joking. When you're next to the store, go to like the there'll be a section with loads of packaged rice, right? Go find yourself like five, maybe go experiment with a load of flavors you think you might like. Make them into sandwiches. Each pack should be about three sandwiches, and what you can do is this: you microwave it, you make three sandwiches, and then you can snack on those throughout the morning or the evening. Right, so you do your breakfast, you have a big lunch, and then part of your lunch you make the sandwiches and then you just put them in your thing. Then whilst you're walking around, snack on a rice sandwich. You know, I'm not joking. You want to gain weight, that's probably the most broken method to do it. And the cool thing is you can change the flavor of the rice every day. You can do rice, you can do lemon and lime, you can do peri peri, you can do katsu curry, you can do there's like tons of different ones you can do. That's like the best thing about it, that method. If you're feeling boring, you could probably go for sushi rice. If you're feeling adventurous, you could go for sushi rice and then you can make yourself some onigiri. I wear black cargo pants for uniform, so I have one pocket dedicated to food. Oh, you can get yourself a little baggie for your sandwich, for your sandwiches. Streamy stream? Huh? What? Are we already 45 minutes in? We've already had like a type train where we'd like, what the fuck? It's okay, my mind. Okay. I promise, by the way, Wednesday, definitely gonna be doing the stream. The other stream, I was just kind of in my head on Thursday because of all the shit. But everything should be fine now. I'm still having problems with OBS, by the way. I'm really, 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 really fucking properly tempted to just try and make do up until TwitchCon EU. And then the week I go out to TwitchCon EU, I'm going to do a reinstall and then just going to try and redo everything over like the week. And the issue I have is I have to keep gummy snacks in my pocket due to low blood sugar. Not super bad, but sometimes if I'm not careful, I get dizzy. Do you want to know what's really funny? I find it really, really interesting how people who get really, really dizzy assume it's low blood sugar and not dehydration. I tend to borderline faint more from lack of hydration than I do from low blood sugar. Like, I'm not even lightly exaggerating. I have not... I give myself one sugary drink a week because I like it as a pick-me-up on the weekend to give me a bit more energy. Literally just because I want a sugary energy drink. And it just makes me feel... It's moderation. But, like... I find it really funny. I would drink more water if you felt like that. You shouldn't need to have gummies and stuff to keep your blood sugar up and stuff. Hi, Jinx! Good morning, hun! How are you doing? You doing okay? How was your week? That's where I'm good. I keep my water bottle in my right thigh pocket, but always full of vitamin water and lemonade mix. Cool fit, by the way. Actually, snack. Do you want to know what's really, really funny? If you think you struggle with your blood sugar levels, the rice sandwiches will help keep your sugar, your glucose, it should in theory keep your glucose levels up and averaged over a longer period of time. Try the rice sandwich approach. I'm not gonna joke. They kind of feel like you would benefit massively from them, because you need to think of it like this. The sugar you have is just glucose, which is what your body uses for energy. But the funny thing is the glucose is a carbohydrate. So the sugar gets turned into glucose in your body, right? But if it's a non-complex carbohydrate like sugar is, it does it really, really quickly and you burn off the energy. Going for the rice sandwich will just keep that going for way longer. I'm stalling with standing on her scale. Oh, Dakota, are you trying to lose weight as well? Or are you trying to gain weight? I've lost 5 pounds this week. But you got this, hun. I believe in you. 2.5 kilograms, by the way. Right? Yeah. 2.5 kilograms. Bum, 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 bum. Bum. Boom. Anyway, what did you guys get up to this week? Did you guys do anything fun? Did you do anything interesting? Did you get yourself anything good? Did you get yourself any have a really lovely snack day? Did I miss a birthday? By chance? Did I miss a fucking birthday? I hope I didn't miss a birthday. I'm a normal as heck. I eat an entire sheet. It's in a single sitting. If it's sitting there, I have nothing else to do. That's called board snacking. Yes, lose, though the rough end of last year bumped me above 100 kilograms, so I want to drop to 95 again. Oh, you've got this, hon. I can't remember what my, was it? Alexa, 260 pounds in kilograms.
260 pounds is about 118 kilograms.
I'm 118. My goal for TwitchCon is to try and get down to 100. That's actually kind of my, I think that should be a reasonable goal for me to go for. So by TwitchCon EU, I'm going to be 100 kilograms, which puts me in a really, really good position. Alexa, 100 kilograms in pounds? Alexa, 100 kilograms in pounds.
100 kilograms is about 220 pounds.
Yeah, that feels reasonable. 220 pounds. And then that gives me 2.5 months or so to try and lose 50 pounds. 2.5 months. So that's 10 weeks? 10 weeks? 2, 4, 8. Yeah. 10 weeks to try and lose 50 pounds, which is roughly 5 pounds a week, which is reasonable for me. Though, I know for a fact that by the time I get closer to it, it's going to be way harder. But after TwitchCon EU, I'm planning to double down on going to the gym daily. I'm just hoping that this fucking blister on my foot fucks off soon so I can maybe go for a run again. I'm 70 kilograms, but I'm a small person. You a small bean? Do you want uppies? Do you want uppies? Do you want me to give you uppies? Come here. I'm gonna give you, oh, hi. Hi, buddy. You like uppies, huh? Do you like uppies? You like uppies? Yeah, you like uppies. Here we go. Yay. Yeah. You got uppies, let's go. Panic. Why are you panicking? Stop panicking. This is a magical moment for us, Taris. Stop panicking. Taris, stop panicking. Okay, I'll put you down. Ready? Down. Ready? There you go. You're fine. You're fine. You're fine. You, no pickup. You wanted uppies. Jinx wanted uppies. You didn't want uppies. You could have just walked away. I'm 52 kilograms, 170. I'm 181 centimeters. No pickup. Me at 6'2 and 218. Personally, I am 1,700 and it's enough for me. Hi, Wolfie! Hi, hi! Hi! Hi, hi! Oh, it's gonna be fun. I can figure out how to do that because you guys are gonna sneak it. Oh, I need to find out how to get an iPad, by the way. I've looked at them. They are terrifyingly small. They are terrifyingly thin. Like, I'm definitely getting one. But they are definitely weirdly small. I'm gonna need a case for it. That's, like, the hard part. I need a case for the fucker, and I'm gonna get the pen outright because I ain't fucking paying extra. I want to make it to around 209 pounds and not go above 220 pounds again. You need a proper daily routine. You need to watch what you're eating. Dakota, I'm going to recommend everyone this diet if they've never tried it before, but the zigzag diet is probably the best diet you could do. It genuinely is probably one of the best diets I've ever been on. It's super fucking simple. It's super simple. It doesn't restrict you a lot, and it actually lets you eat what you want. But it's basically calorie count, get it as low as you want. I recommend if you want to do slow loss around the 1,100 mark day, but then on the weekends you can bump that up to about 2,200. So 2,200, 2,400 on Saturday and Sunday, 1,100 on a weekday. You should lose about 1 to 3 pounds a week doing that. And the cool thing is you can do it indefinitely because your body doesn't get used to the diet. It's about averaging your week. See, with me, it's Monday to Friday. I'll do 700 to 900 calories a day because I'm doing the crash variant, which goes harder on the Monday to Friday. But on the weekend, I could go, YOLO, fuck it. I'm having ice cream later. That's like the great thing. I can have what I want on the weekend, and I've been losing fucking... I've lost 20 pounds in 3 weeks. Alexa, 20 pounds in kilograms?
20 pounds is about 9.1 kilograms.
Yeah, I've lost close to 10 kilograms in the past 3 weeks. So... doing something right. Actually. Yeah. I can hit the goal by TwitchCon. We're like 5-6 weeks away from it. Oh god, we're 5-6 away. We're about 6 weeks away from TwitchCon EU. This year's going too quick. Slow down. Who gave this year permission to go so fucking quick? We're almost halfway into the fucking year. What the fuck? It felt like yesterday was like January. Who the fuck gave it permission to do that? I don't like that. Don't do that. I'm gonna... I forgot to do this before the stream. I did me Speedy Boy. What was working for me is just to make sure I don't go above 2,500 calories and go for a small round around the block. Sure, one day above the point, but it's fine. But not all day. Dakota, the thing is you're trying to lose weight, so you need to try and pull a 500 deficit to lose roughly 1 pound a day. 500 calorie deficit a day is 1 pound loss a week. So if you want to lose 2 pounds a week, which is regarded as being safe, you need to be on 1,000 calories deficit. So if you want to lose weight, you should be aiming for about 1,500. 2,500 is recommend for maintain weight, but you should be trying to go for about 1,500. I'm going to suggest the zigzag diet. You can figure it out and just track it easily. But I will say this though. Track your weight on like a spreadsheet. Give yourself, do a calendar, do a spreadsheet, track the loss. And just make it and stuff, and then do a separate one and track your measurements. If you have a bad weight loss week, but a good slim week, you're still happy. Because you can lose weight and not slim, and you can slim down and not lose weight. It can go both ways. So tracking both just keeps you mentally motivated in the long run. Just saying. I gave it permission. I wanted to be groundskeeper again. You must enjoy being a groundskeeper. Go to the convention or pounds to kilograms. You need to divide by 2.2 the other way. Kilograms to pounds is multiplied by 2.2. Huh? Maintain? Huh? Maximum to maintain your weight slash height would be 2,900 calories. So I am on a deficit of 400 calories already. Dakota, my top advice is don't go off of what your current weight is. Go off of your goal weight. So if you want to be 95 kilograms, do it off of 95 kilograms, not 100 kilograms. Does that make sense? I have mine off of my calorie deficit is based off of my goal weight, not my current weight. Do you want to know why? Because otherwise you're going to end up, what you end up doing is you end up like eating way more and your weight loss isn't as good. But what you'll find that happens is If you're like, say, 300-400 pounds like I used to be, and your go weight is 170 like mine is, your weight loss starts off really, really, really rapidly, and then it slows down, and it slows down, and it slows down. I'm predicting my last like 5 pounds, my last like 10 or so pounds is going to take me like 5-6 weeks. Because I'm going to be really slow at that point. There's no shame to be overweight. You're not wrong, I see. There is no shame in being overweight. There's no shame in being underweight. There's no shame in being fat. There's no shame in being skinny. If you're a single person, if you're a single Pringle and you are desperate, if you're a single Pringle and you're desperate to get into a relationship and you can't figure out why, for the life of you, why can't you find yourself a relationship? I have one word. One very simple and neat trick for you. It's called take care of yourself. Go for walks. Do a simple 20-30 minute walk a day. Drink plenty of water. Have a bath or a shower every day. Just keep yourself clean and keep your room clean. That's all you need. You don't need money. You don't need a big expensive car. You don't need bullshit. You don't need all the crap that the goddamn Tate brothers has been slapping around online for the past few fucking years. You don't need any of that bullshit. All you need to do to get where you want in life, to get into a relationship that you want, is take care of yourself. That's all girls want. That's all they want. Take care of yourselves. I'm not cute, Golden. Shut up. I'll take a sip in a moment. Like, I'm 61 kilograms and 6-9 people say I'm skinny, and I'm like, yeah, I know. I met, was it? The person who sold me the phone yesterday was a really, really lovely girl. She has an eating disorder, and she freely talked to me about it. She was very comfortable talking to me about her eating disorder. The fact that she was in a... We seemed to hit it off quite well. No, we're not going to go on a date. Shut the fuck up. I know what you guys are like. No, I'm not going to go on a date with this person. But they are, they were anorexic. They had an abusive relationship and their reaction was to starve themselves. And they were apparently very, very small. And they told me that they gained like 10 pounds in the last month or two. And I went, that's really, I literally gave her some really good positive motivation. I said, that's really, really cool. I told her that I lost like 60 pounds in the last like, I can say it now. In the last 3 months, I've lost like 60 pounds. So that's like 20 pounds a month, which is why I'm pretty sure I'll be fine for TwitchCon. But yeah, I told her that. And she's like, wow, that's really, really good. The reason why we were talking like that is because the system was slow. We needed to wait for shit to load. And we got talking. And I'm a professional yapper. I will yap all fucking day. Is Katie the one who can't read? I'm dyslexic! Katie got bird. I got bird? Katie going to TwitchCon? I'm doing both TwitchCons! I'm doing both. Wanna eat up with me and friends? I'm going with my manager, who is also technically... I'm going with my manager and I'm meeting up with other people. I will be going with a Sharpie though. If you want me to sign anything, I'll be happy to sign stuff. I have a autograph and everything. I can show you my autograph, actually. Do you want to see my autograph? Who's your manager? Well, technically, I'm going with my community manager. I've known them for about fucking 6 years. Fucking trust him with math. I'm going to show you my autograph. And this is my autograph, not my signature. My signature is way different. Wait, we'll be all right. You want to see it? I'm bodyguard. Technically, yes, they are. I'm technically also my bodyguard. You want to see my signature? You want to see my autograph? My autograph is... I need a dark background. Oh, that should be fine. That's my autograph. It's actually my autograph. Except what I should do, which I'm going to do, is we're gonna go like that, and we're gonna go bonk, bonk. I'm gonna go like that at the end of it instead. Autograph! Do you like it? Noah's a body girl, really. Neil is my manager, actually. And I'm out from out. Welcome back for the ads! Do you like it? My signature's way different. I'm not showing you that though, because that's for private reasons. That's for professional reasons. Ads stuff and it kind of reveals my name. It should only be 2 minutes. It doesn't matter how many ads, it should only be 2 minutes. Ain't no way I know him. Neelam Khanna? He's in my Discord. Yeah, he's in my Discord. Yeah, I paid for his TwitchCon ticket. That's my payment. My payment to him is his TwitchCon ticket. That is how much, that is my payment to him. He has Cinder's old manager. He was Cinder's old manager. Yeah, he's my manager. He's my community manager now. I technically am trying to find a community, social media manager and stuff. That's 2 minutes I missed of you talking about weight loss. It's okay, I'll be in the fucking, they'll be on the VOD. So what are you all looking forward to this weekend? I get ice cream. I get ice cream. Also need a bodyguard. I technically have a bodyguard. That's what Neil's for. I will be going incognito though. I'm going to wear a mask. I gotta get myself a comfy fabric mask. And learn how to wear it with glasses. I might start doing that actually. I might find myself a comfy fabric mask to go with. Are you okay, Kerberos? What's wrong? Nice and stylish. Oh, thank you. I've been practicing. Relaxing before my mother forces me to watch a damn movie. Give her a hug and lick her cheek. She won't know what hits her. She go, thank you, mom. She won't know what hit her. It always throws my mom off when I do that. Band-aids near the nose, so I can't escape. Band-aids near the nose, so air can't escape. I heard what you do is you fold the corners down. I literally heard that's all you gotta do with a mask to stop it from fogging your glasses is take the nose bit and fold it over and it forces the air to go out sideways. Okay, I could be your bodyguard and I'll bring my army canine. No, I'm afraid of fucking dogs, dude. There's only one dog there's two dogs I will get, let myself go near. One is with her. Sorry, I got so sorry. I was thinking about her. And Maeve, yeah. Maeve's my papa. Maeve broke her fucking yoga ball the other day. She broke her fucking yoga ball being a lap princess. She was being a pillow princess. And she broke her fucking yoga ball. How? Actually, I know how. Her room is tiny. Her room is way smaller than mine. A bit deflated. Typical dog behavior. Yeah, you know what dogs are like. They're gonna fucking break a ball at some point. Apparently, it went bang and she hit her ass on the floor. That's what she told me. Bro, he is a sweetheart. Hun, I've had 3 dogs in my life bite me. All of them, the owners said, oh, he's a sweetheart. He don't bite. Every one of them has bitten me. I don't trust dogs. I'm fucking cautious around dogs. Every time I hear a dog bark, I get fucking... Biggest jump scare. Even if I'm right in front of them and I see them about to do it, I still get jump scared. I'm a stray wild vixen. I can slightly understand what dogs are like. If he bites, I put him down. If he... Let me read it that way. If he bites, I punt him. I don't care. This is how I imagine Katie when she talks. Huh?
My dog is just hyper when people are around.
There's only one dog type I'm less cautious around, and it's a fucking husky, because they're essentially a fox. And foxes are essentially a confusion of dog and cat. A pet fox and a pet husky are like the two... A pet fox and a pet husky are like the two dumbest variants of dog you can get.
That was my dad.
What about a Labrador? I've been bitten by two Labradors. I actually really don't trust labs. I got bitten by a chocolate and a cream one. And a golden one.
I could get an army husky, I'll just have to call Alaska.
Han, I don't want a bodyguard. I've got my... Neil's gonna be there to protect me. Hi, Volp! Hi, how? Oh yeah, I got told to take a sip. I'm gonna have some...
I'm gonna drink.
I'm gonna have orange juice. I have orange juice. I'm gonna get orange juice.
Yeah, let's go. Oh, it's a big ass carton. I'm regretting getting orange juice.
Oh.
You okay?
Hi. Hi, welcome to the stream. I'm sorry what you see now is my ass. I'm just getting a drink. Hello? Hello?
Take her, she they're harmless.
Ah, chihuahuas are the worst because they're yappers. They're little yap goblins.
Foxes are like a cat in a dog's body.
So is a husky. Dwinks. Hi, Koi. Hi.
What about a doge? You mean a shibi? They're just derps.
Yeah, but I don't like yappy dogs. That's like the thing. I actually don't like yappy dogs. Three dogs I've been bitten by. One was a Jack Russell. Another one was a chocolate lab, and the other one was a golden retriever. both of the fucking Labradors were really fucking poorly trained. I have a boxer bull mastiff mix. I'm not a dog person. There's a reason why I'm a neckerbus and not a pupperbus. Oh god, don't tell Maeve that one. Please don't tell Maeve I said pupperbus. That sounds like such a good combination for her. Twitch doesn't look like me today. Anubis, is your Twitch lagging? Because mine's been lagging for the last 2 days. It's not just you. It's me as well.
My dog will sit on your foot and give you puppy eyes.
Saint Bernard? I'm not a dog person. I genuinely mean it when I say I am not fond of dogs. I'm a cat person. I have a partial phobia of dogs. I'm very cautious. If there is a dog and it's higher than my knee, I'm terrified. If I hear a dog bark, I'm terrified. If a black dog, specifically a black dog, in the middle of the night walk towards me, I fucking will collapse and die on the spot. I'm terrified of that. I'm not just saying that to... It's like... All you will see is the eyes, and then the teeth, and then that's it, your throat's gone. That is like the there is videos online of this fucking wolfhound fucking thing wandering around in the middle of the fucking night, and it's fucking Vanta black, and you're like, what is that? And then it walks out into the light, you still can't see it, but then you see the silhouette, and you go, no, stop, nature... You fucking tripping. Go back, rewind, delete it. You fuck. I want that update abolished. Please get rid of that update. Fuck you guys.
You have a problem with black dogs?
No, a black dog in the middle of the night is just genuinely just a bleh. It's just because all you get is the silhouette of the dog, and that's just fear. There's a reason why, oh god, they're seen as an omen.
Dogs are man's creation, we did it to ourselves.
Yes, but the fucking wolf is the backbone of the papa. I like papas. Dogs are a no. I don't like dogs. Why are you trying to convince me I like dogs? I don't like dogs. You don't like, I'm not a papa lover. I'm a cat.
Beagles?
I used to have a husky pit. I can't remember. I had a dog called Lady when I was younger, and my parents had to get rid of her because she wouldn't let my parents get near me. Thank you for the follow, welcome to the stream. Also, hi Anubis.
But what about a massive bunny like the Flemish giant?
You mean the derp thing? You know you can pick those up by their ears, right?
I wouldn't recommend it. You'll probably kill them or behead them because they're fucking dumb.
I'm a cat person. I like cats. I'm the type of psycho with cats. I am genuinely the type of psycho with a cat where if I saw a fucking tiger or a lion, I would try and pet it. I'm like, oh, hi, kitty. I would literally just be like, standing there, I see a tiger, a lion, a fucking mountain lion in America. I would be, do not leave me on my own when I'm in America. Okay, if I get left on my own and we're in an area and I see a fucking mountain lion, my response is to try and fucking pet the fucker. It's not gonna be to run the other way, it's gonna be kitty. It's just gonna be going after the fucking thing, trying to pet it and domesticate it, going, I want to take care of you because I think you fluffy and I think you good. I got to pet a cat yesterday. I was so happy. And then I got a phone, and I was extra happy. Take that, depression.
I'm not depressed, by the way. You can do what bunny is? Depending on the rabbit, you get them by the scruff of the neck. There's like a thing where when they're dead, you hold them by the ears. My dog's little sister is like a tiny 7-pound like cat with an attitude. You know what though, I see you having cats, but you know what I pet I'd imagine you having? A bunny or a guinea pig or a hamster?
Okay, I had a rabbit when I was younger, and I had a guinea pig when I was younger. I've also had 3 cats in my life, and a hamster, and a goldfish. No, I had 4 cats. We had a kitten called Fred, we had a gerbil called Fred, and we had a goldfish called Fred.
My dad has an obsession with calling things Fred. I actually might talk to dad. I might say, hey, we should get a little fish tank. Just a little cheapy one, but get some goldfish.
I've pet an Arctic fox. I've pet a fucking eagle. Oh yeah, I've also owned...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
8... I've owned 10 African gay... If there was a rainbow version of the African grey parrot, as in its foliage, its plume, because it's got red tail feathers, if there was a fucking, I swear to fuck, if there was a version where the plume was rainbow, could we call it the African gay parrot? Because it would be so cool! Looks identical, but the fucking red plume is rainbow. We could call it the African gay parrot. I love that. I really, really love that as an idea. It works so well, and it's just getting rid of one letter.
I think.
Ah, fuck my face. I forgot to take my antihistamines to die. Good morning.
Hi, Volps. Hi, hi. What's your opinions on ferrets? I think ferrets are adorable, but they're problematic and they're a lifestyle. They're not a pet. It would be as camp singing Fred wants a cracker. Ah, I forgot to take my fucking antihistamines and now I'm getting fucked in the face by fucking pollen. It's a pollen rich day. Fuck. Fuck my face. Jesus. Okay, want me to turn on my PC to lurk? Or are you fine with me not lurking while I walk? Dakota, I think that's more up to you than not to me. I think that's way more up to you than it is me. I don't think it's my decision if you want to lurk or not. If you want to lurk, you can lurk. If you want to save a bit of electricity and not, then you don't need to lurk. I'm not gonna crucify you for it. Ah! Actually, I haven't seen who's on yet. I know there was a party last night and it ran on into this morning. They're DJing. Hi, Sam. No crucifixion, damn shame. I give the follow up to the stream. I hope you enjoy your time here. Yeah, Sam, how have you been? You been okay? Hi, Devstroyer. Hi, hi. Oh, I'm not getting first time chatter pop-ups in my screen. Give me a second. I need to... I think it might be... I've had to change some stuff. Right. Hiya. I'm gonna put that there. Hi. Sorry, I moved it so I can see more things now. I should have taken my antihistamines. Alright, if you're still streaming after I get back, then I'll see you then. Okay, have a wonderful walk, hon. Mwah. Thank you. It's not my birthday, Sim! Why did I only just pick up that you said happy birthday to me? Fucking no, I'm not birthday. Bad. Have I missed more first time chatters? I did. Oh wait, no, that's the same. It's just. It's not my birthday. Mm-mm. It's not my birthday, fuck off. It's not my birthday. No second hype train, no bullshit, no nothing. Sim, stop. Shut up. Pregnant? I'm not pregnant. If I was pregnant, you should subscribe so I could feed the baby. But I'm not pregnant, so you don't need to subscribe. And there's no baby to feed. I'm gonna put that on a shirt, subscribe so I can feed the baby, that, and then in brackets, that doesn't exist. This community seems chaotic, so I must stay. We've been talking about weight loss and, like, eating disorders for the past, like, hour and a half. I'm not even lightly exaggerating. We've been talking about fucking food and eating disorders and weight loss and weight gain for, like, the past, like, hour or so. I don't know why. We just roll with the punches here. Confirmation of Katie having baby. I'm not pregnant. I'm not pregante. Dogs too. Also puppies. Yeah. Yeah, that was a thing. Hi, Pickle. Good morning. How are you doing, Toto? Watermelon. Watermelon makes me throw up. Buff Papa. Oh. Ugh. Oh, I can smell my dad's cooking and I'm getting hungry. Apple, yeah. I like apples. Apples are nice. What the fuck is that emote? Oh, Pikachu ramen. Oh, I am fine. How are you, Katie? I'm doing good. I'm hoping you're doing okay. I would like to put a color on. Were you gonna say what you would like to put a collar on me? You're gonna like what I've got planned, by the way, Jake. I bet you're not gonna like. You're gonna really fucking like what I got planned. I'll go away, stupid emote thing. I'm running on, I don't know what I'm running on right now. I am running on random fuel. I woke up, I had a coffee. I went store with my dad, because we go store every Saturday. It's kind of turned into a ritual for us. It's really, really nice. I came home, I had a salad. I had some yogurt, which I kind of really didn't like, and I kind of remembered, oh yeah, shit, I shouldn't get that brand. I remember why I didn't like that brand anymore. It's just mostly water. I had rice pudding, and I had some gluten-free cupcakes, blueberry ones. I'm gonna have some chocolate buttons after the stream. Mm-hmm. And then I'm gonna have my dad cooking, and then I'm gonna have ice cream, and then tomorrow I'm way back on my dad. Rice pudding is yum. Pyro. Not only was it rice pudding, it was salted caramel rice pudding. Salted caramel rice pudding. Oh, so fucking nice. Yeah. Salted caramel rice pudding. Talking about it right now. Sploosh. Did you spill any on yourself? Nah, I didn't waste a single fucking drop.
Why would I waste a single drop? It was fucking...
It was... salted caramel. Rice pudding. What the heck is rice pudding? Are you American? Are you American by chance? It's okay. Rice pudding is like milk and cream. It's like milk and cream with rice boiled, and then it's got sugar in it. It's very, it's really, really nice. It's a form, I think it's a form of British diet. It's really nice. Trust me. It's really, if you've ever had custard and you really like custard, you will fucking love, you will fucking kill for rice pudding. Rice pudding is one of those meals where if you're left on a desert island and you're left with an unlimited supply of one thing, I would take rice pudding. I would take rice pudding. What is custard? Huh? Some of you need to go into the dessert aisle. Fuck me. I'm a fan of custard, to be honest. Rice pudding, but sweet. Oh, rice, yeah, rice, it's like porridge, but it's sweet. Sorry, I've got crap on my eyes. I had sour apple vodka earlier, it was yummy. So I'm planning to get really drunk at TwitchCon US. I'm actually planning to get kind of really drunk at TwitchCon US. I'm not gonna lie, I'm really planning to get properly drunk at TwitchCon US. And I'm not yet decided, I might have some edibles. might give them a little gander at TwitchCon US, just to see, just to might as well type deal. But I'm gonna have to talk to my friends and be like, they need to be gluten free, because if they have gluten, I'm gonna be on the shitter all night and be crying. Be crying, and I'm gonna associate it with shits. Rice pudding with red sauce? No. Katie's so cute and adorable. No! Lies! I would take an unlimited supply of burgers. I would take an unlimited supply of rice pudding. Do you want to know why rice pudding is a great idea for when for if you're trapped on a desert island? It's carbohydrates. It's calcium. It's sugar. It's vitamins, minerals, and and I think it's got a little bit of protein in it because of the cream. And because it's non-specific, you can have different flavors of rice pudding, including different jams. So you essentially go YOLO fuckins, and you do it that way. The only problem is you will eventually get the shits, because there's not tons of fiber in it. I stick with omitted tacos, and it has almost everything you need. I agree. Ah, snack. Here's the problem, though. You say unlimited tacos. Unless you're specific, you're going at tacos. You want filled tacos. Otherwise, you're just going to get taco shells. And then you fucked. I also here with snack. I have sand dirt so much. And also around me. So that means insects. So that means more food. Oh yeah, but technically, yeah. Pudding tacos. Do you know what I'm really surprised at? Why hasn't Mr. Beast done a challenge where he takes, say, five people to choose one thing to survive on and see how long they survive on it for? Jimmy, if you see this, do a challenge where someone gets unlimited of one food. The desert island food. Just do a desert island itself thing. Because they die. But that's the thing. Everyone will have different ideas. Can you imagine the person that can order? Consider this. You can order. You order the food through them, right? But you have to have one type. So you could turn around and say pizza. You say pizza, broad spectrum pizza. Do you want to know why? Vegetable pizza, meat pizza. You could do stupid adventurous stuff on pizza. You could do dumb stuff on pizza. You could go dessert pizza, normal pizza, breakfast pizza. You can wake up and have a margarita pizza. Yeah, human adults can't survive on one thing. I think you would be surprised, but like, I'm surprised Jimmy hasn't thought about doing that one yet. Broad spectrum tacos. Have you ever eaten some caramelized crickets with cricket as peanuts? I have had crickets before. I found them very better than I was expecting. It's the only way I can describe it. Now all I can think of is Bart survival food from a Tremors movie, MREs. But yeah, they should. I'm surprised he hasn't thought about doing that yet. Oh, my ankle really fucking hurts. Crunchy cricket? Crunchy crickets? Poppity ping pizza! Poppity ping pizza! But can you imagine the person? Okay, can you imagine this? You have one person choose tacos, one person choose pizza. You have another person probably choose burgers, and they'll probably be the worst off out of all of them. Granted, they could just keep changing it, but there's so much bread. Granted, pizza's way more bread. But yeah. Cute streamer. Nuh-uh, fuck you. I'm not cute, shut up. No. Uh-uh. You don't get here to be here for 12 minutes and call me fucking cute. No. Fuck you, no. No. Pyro. Bad, no. Honey pizza covered in bees. You make cute noises. No, I don't. I step on my floorboard and make squeaky sounds. Tacos. I could have fish tacos, beef tacos, pork tacos, venison tacos, breakfast tacos, and dessert tacos. Yeah, that's the thing. It would be really, really interesting to see who could last the longest on one doing that type of challenge. Doing that type of challenge. Because mentally speaking, you want the variety.
But strictly speaking, you remove the variety and you give them one thing. Who will last the longest?
Queen QB.
No, Kara! Sure.
Meat lovers pizza?
Yeah, pizza's like a solid option. But it's so much more carbs and probably tons of fucking salt.
Rats make squeaky noises and even the ones in my walls are cute.
Don't domesticate your rats. Don't domesticate your wall buddies. Oh my god, what the fuck?
Are they allowed to drink water? Rats make squeaky noises and even... Wait.
Yeah, they'll be allowed to drink water. You can't remove water from the equation. The whole point would be is that their main food. They have one food, unlimited supply of one type of food. That is the whole point.
If it's me, I think I would survive the longest given I don't have to build a shelter. I can survive a large storm.
I mean, the idea would be is you have, the idea would be is you have four identical rooms. And like, say four identical rooms, or maybe even five or six. Say you could do six or eight identical rooms in like a circle. And then each person goes into one of the rooms. They choose what they want, and they go into each of the rooms. And they have to survive on that for as long as possible. And they don't know when the other people have come out. Not a joke, by the way. I actually have rats. They eat all the crap that isn't in the fridge.
That's not good. Sounds like a sim... experiments.
Yeah, it's kind of. That's just Mr. Beast at this point, except he doesn't use Sims, he uses real people.
Okay, would they be allowed to supply us with, say, books?
You'll be allowed basic entertainment, communication between each other, or wouldn't be allowed. Because the idea is they're meant to isolate from each other. And they're meant, so no internet. They can watch movies, they can read books, they could technically play video games, though not online, so they'll have to stick with like old retro-y style games.
Yeah. Remember Big Brother?
Yeah, it's still going on in the UK.
Just not as popular as it used to be. Isolate me from everything, just give me books.
For me, I would need something to draw with. I'm not actually gonna lie, I would do fine with like an art supply.
Huge streamer.
No! No! Duh! Shh.
Good morning, Kate. How I sleep well.
Congratulations, I'm glad you slept well, hon. I'm happy for you. Probably slept way better than me. I kind of
struggled to sleep last night.
Had loads of energy. So yesterday I got ready for stream. I did everything ready for stream. And then I got the text and was like, hey, your phone's ready. You should come and pick it up. And I was like, fucking fine. I want a new phone.
Can you say shush a lot?
I say shut up. I don't say shush. I say shoo as well.
You're cute.
No, fuck you, Zoname. No. Bad.
Mm-mm.
No.
Mm. If I book a safe for months.
Imagine if there was a... Because they could do it so there's like a big prize as well. They could do like a... $1 million prize or some shit.
Can you say shut up a lot?
I'm not you, fuck you! No.
Do for 1 million, I'd go for months.
Yeah, but that's the thing. Everyone would be thinking, I can go for months, I can go for months, I can go for a long time, I can go for a long time.
Oh, look, my basic bitch phone night. F the stream.
Kara. It's my first new phone in like 5 fucking years. Cut me a break. I wanted my new phone. I could have gone after that. I could have done a short stream for like 2 hours and then gone. But I said, you know what? I haven't taken a break from Twitch in... I haven't taken a stream break on Twitch in like like a month and a half, 2 months, which is really good for me. One day off in like a month and a half, not bad. Gonna save up a lot of channel points. Are you going for the 1 million point redeem? Good luck with that. I think Taris is the closest at like 920 odd thousand at this point. Give me books and an NES with Final Fantasy 1 through 6 with tacos and I'm set for life. Pillow and blanket life. No, it'll be so funny because like you'll just have people, you'll have people going in and they'll give advice of which ones that you can go for and who can last the longest. But here's the thing. Do you do it so there's only one of each and then they have to choose which one they go for? Or do you have it so two of them can choose pizzas, two of them can choose tacos, two of them can choose burgers, they could do whatever. By the sink, under my heater, in my closet, and probably even more my dad's house, in particularly dilapidated. Oh, Pyro, there's some, what was it, what was the recipe? Flour and water with peanut butter mixed in. 50% flour, 50% water, mix in peanut butter. It kills them. There's a mix that you can do which kills rats because their stomachs can't absorb it. And it just locks, it just solidifies their stomachs and stops them from being able to consume it. It's like 50% water, 50% flour, and you mix in some peanut butter into it so they get the urge to eat it. Because it rises in their stomachs. I'm a little bit late. You're fine, Trog. I can't remember. I could talk to my dad. If you're here on the next stream, I could get the thing for it. Kate is one letter away from QE. No, it isn't. You're lying. Lies. I assume you got the Apple for face tracking. I got the note. I got the 15 Pro Max. I have my case for it coming tomorrow and a MagSafe charger. So when I'm streaming, I can just keep it on the MagSafe charger and it keeps it charging. And because it's MagSafe, it's super secure. And I'm like, I'm not joking. I played around with the MagSafe at the Apple store and I was like, how secure would you say MagSafe is? And they looked at me and said, very. And they were like, what? It's like, very. All of these are MagSafe. And I looked around the store and I went, no, these are like security held on things, aren't they? He said, no, they're all MagSafe. I went up to one of the iPhones and I pulled it and it's so strong. The MagSafe shit is so fucking strong. I'm like, I'm surprised, holy shit. But yeah, I got the iPhone for the face tracking. And I'm honestly just loving all the little features, like the Find My Friend thing, the Apple AirTag shit. Perfect second monitor content, not gonna lie. What do you mean by Hive? KE and QE equals same thing. Listen. No. No, they're not, because I'm not cute. I'm not cute. I don't know where you keep getting these fucking lies from. I'll give Apple a pass for their security, but the OS is trash. I feel like a lot of the time Apple's problems is largely just oversight because they think they're secure and the reality is they're kind of not. Yes, you are. No, I'm not. I will die on this hill, cool cutie. Ah. No, I'm not cute. Nope. Can't download third-party apps on Apple iPhone. They've recently had a law pass that means actually you will be able to, because they kind of have to do it. They have to approve the secondary stores, though. I will die with you. You're cute. No! No. No. Do I need to get a bot? How desperate? How many of you in chat right now? Okay. Type in one right now if you would get a body pillow of me if I were to get one. Like, how many of you would get a body pillow? If it was, say, around, I want to say $90 to $100, around the $100 mark. Would you do it if it was around the $100 mark? Because that's roughly how much they would end up costing anyway. Sorry, I don't buy body pillows. Damn. What about mouse pads? Would you do a mouse pad snack? Worm reminds I donate for it already. I changed that goal, by the way, to just be merch. And if we make enough in 1 month, that it'll be the goal. I'll pay my mouse pad. Mouse pads? As in, like, I have a desk mat. I don't like mouse pads. I like desk mats. I like the whole space. Okay, admit it. No. Nah. But I have returned. Gotta get used to me smelling like babies because I have Zoetis deodorant. Normally Zoetil sells mainly skincare products instead of intended for babies, toddlers, and preschoolers. So I smell like babies at the moment. Wow! Why are you getting that? That's not designed for you. I'd buy it if it has extra. I would do a version of it with extra stuff. Good morning, Aniel. How are you doing today? My lower back hurts. I had to change. So because I have a fucking huge blister on my my heel, I've had to change my walk gait. I fucking hate it. Not cute. Cute noises, no, and you proved our point. No, I didn't. I kind of know. Not how that works. Oh, the double not safe body pillow. I will do two body pillows. I'll do the safe for work version and the very not safe for work version. They're huge investments though. Fuck, it's so expensive. I'm a bit hungry, but otherwise I'm fine. Awesome. Apart from the whole being hungry thing, but that's fixable with some food. No, I'm not going to. There have been people here for years at this point trying to get me to say that, Hannah, and I'm not. You're making me pull out the gifted sub for this. It's not gonna work. Taris, how many subs have you gifted at this point? I know you're here. How many gifted subs have you gifted to me at this point and not had me admit what I'm not? I mean it. No. Because I'm not. And very not safe one. I'll have my safe for work one, my not safe for work one, and the this is hentai one. Which I am, but I'm also touch starved. Well, that's if I'm food hungry. Oh, you're touch starved? It's okay, hon. It's okay.
Onii-chan! I have a dick!
Dakota, thank you so much for the 28 Katie, months.
Katie, I bestow upon you the cute with my 28-month resub.
You just admitted that you were cute. I bestow upon you the cute with my 28-month sub. But isn't that you admitting that you're cute? I mean, Dakota, I've seen you. You are definitely cute. Good morning. Good morning, Cal! Hi. See, when it comes to merch, I'd probably say doing them on just a purchase basis would be safest. Snack, I'm partnered with a company, and the company I'm partnered with literally prints to order, but it's high quality print to order. It's not cheap shit print to order. The problem I have is I need artists to do the designs so I can sell them. So yeah. I'm not cute. It's because it takes one to know one. I will sit on your face, Dakota. Don't start. OK.
Katie has been titled cute by Dakota. They have no authority to do so. They have no royalty. You're cute, I'm not. Katie, repeat this.
No, I'm not.
Dakota didn't send Miss Katie B a picture proof. Proving her wrong, no.
I can check. Aha. Oh yeah, you are cute. You're adorable. One tip, Dakota, one tip. In the makeup section at a store, you can get little jars. They'll be about, I want to say probably about 4 or 5 euros for the jar. There'll be special moisturizer. I think they're done by L'Oreal. They are godsends. Do not, yeah. Yeah, trust me. They make a world of difference. I went to the store yesterday. The person who was dealing with me thought I was 21. They literally said, oh, this might take a while. You're young, so you probably don't have a credit score. I turned around and said, I'm 31, and according to Experian, my credit score is 977 out of 990. You fuck you mean I'm young? You're like, oh, wait, what? I'm like, yeah, I have a perfect credit score, almost. She went, no way, you're 30. I went, I moisturize, I don't smoke, I very rarely drink, I don't vape, and I exercise regularly. And they were like, wait, is that a secret? Yeah, I was like, well, fuck, I've been vaping for the past 5 years. I went, wow. Or a cream dealer. I'm your nana, hun. I do that. So the only advice I can give to anyone, if you want your skin to look good, fucking moisturize. Actually, Dakota, it just takes time. The hormones and stuff will just hit you overnight. I would fight Goku just to prove the point. In a video game? What kind of cream is it? It's technically just moisturizing cream. I've got issues with a lot of skincare products because of them containing alcohol, so moisturizer causes issues. Good moisturizer should not contain alcohol. If it contains alcohol, it's not a fucking moisturizer because that dries the skin out. The goal of moisturizer is to actually moisturize, not remove moisture. Fun fact, that first resurrection was actually hella tired. Finally stopped getting ID'd at stores when I let my beard grow out. I still get ID'd. I still get ID'd to get energy drinks. I had to say to someone, I got ID'd. In the UK, drinking age is 18. I got ID'd for alcohol because I was buying some Baileys. They ID'd me and I turned around and said to them, dude, it's the middle of the fucking day on a school day. Do I look like I'm trying to skive off of school? And they literally just looked and said to me, fair point. And then they just bleeped me through. I was like, do I look like I'm 18? I got ID'd. It was so stupid. If that's the case, why do they put alcohol in these moisturizers? They shouldn't! I've never had alcohol in my moisturizer. It's probably shit moisturizer. The only time you should ever have alcohol in a moisturizer is when it's a fucking suntan lotion to help with absorption. Can you stop calling Miss Katie B cute, please? That's annoying. Yeah, that's like one of the reasons. If it goes on for a couple of minutes, it's okay. When it goes on for like 20, 30 minutes, it's like, ugh. I feel like you read my about me and just went, I got this. I thought I was naked then. I glanced the camera. I had my hands around here and I forgot I had shorts on. Fucking hell. Let me grab my moisturizer. It would help if this had the ingredients on it.
Sorry. L'Oreal Paris Anti-Wrinkle Hydrating Cream. I got this stuff up people over the edge of that older than me because I'm getting older. Let me check my... You should be here, you should close. Let me check my aloe. Yeah, there's nothing in here which is alcoholic. Yeah, I'm currently holding Vaseline stuff. You're just getting shit stuff on. And it sounds really stupid. When it comes to stuff you put on your body, don't cheap out on it. You should really take care of yourself and splash a bit. I got jump scared by myself. Hi, okay, in chat. How is everyone there? Hi, Doc. How are you doing? I'm doing good today. I'm hoping you're doing okay. How was your week? Did you have a good week? Did you have a good week, hun? Shorts are small. They're classed as panties. No, these are the panties. These are the shorts. This is a belt. And this is a booty. With clipping issues, because I'm stupid. Two-string shorts, I would definitely eat them. What? What? Huh? What did you say, Jake? What? The ultimate Katie snack? What the fuck is wrong with you sometimes? I'm good, I have a good week. Been in volunteering on Thursday and Friday. It went well, but it was so hot. Yeah, it's been really hot this week. I took out twice. I did two walks on a really bad fucking ankle yesterday to get my new phone. And I was like... I got home and I sat down and went, I'm not fucking standing up. I sat down and went, I'm done. I'm not moving from this spot. And I went, fuck, I need to pee. And then I went and peed. Me need food. You need food? I'm going to have chocolate buttons after the... Did someone disconnect? My roommate seems fine. Kara! Fuck you. Hate those. I'm good. I have a good week. Oh wait, I already fucking read that. Fuck sake. Chocolate buttons. I got chocolate caramel buttons. I watched Wonka on Wednesday, by the way. I want chocolate. I got Cadbury's chocolate caramel buttons. Really nice. Oh, by the way, I send you a week zero, aka before I should... Oh, God. You know, you could just turn around and say, I sent you a one before HRT. Oh, God. That is such an amazing difference, hun. I'm so happy for you. I'm so proud. Holy shit. What's going on here? Break my heart and test me. I don't know what I'm doing. Hi. I need water. I am thirsty. Go get water. I have a boil water warning in my area thing, and I hate it. Oh my god, I'm so wet. I'm so wet. Sorry. Bwah. Bwah. Hi, Sheena. How are you doing today? You doing good? You doing okay? I'm hoping you're doing okay. And I'm on the second month of blockers now too. I'll get more. Oh, right. I have a blood test. I think it's not Tuesday coming up, but the week after. I think I've got it on the 28th. Oh yeah, that's not the same screen. Shit. 1 second. I think it's on the 28th. 28th, yeah. Not next Tuesday, but the Tuesday after. I have a blood test on the 28th. And it's a big one. It's doing a allergen check and a hormone and mineral, vitamin and mineral. Go there eventually. Remember to stay hydrated. It's kind of difficult when you have potential poop water. I'm just gonna blame my dad on that, actually. He keeps blocking the toilet. It's kind of funny. It's spreading from Devon. It actually is. We're currently on class one. Apparently, I'm in an area which is class one, which is like the lowest. And my mum is in an area which is a class six, which is you need to fucking boil your water. Yeah, boil water, I hear. About water issue. Yeah, a dodgy valve was taking poop water and putting it in the drink water. One, why is there a valve to dump shit into the drinking supply? Why is that a thing? Why aren't they as separate as possible? Why is that a thing? Like, sir, what technical genius thought, yeah, we're gonna have a valve that lets the poop water into the drink water. Like, why is that? Let's disconnect it. It should be a thing. What the fuck? Okay, so the water system was built in the Victorian days. You are not wrong. But it's a lot more modernized now than it was before. So what? Fucking genius thought, yeah, we're gonna make it so poop water gets in with the drinking water. And what the fuck? This way, please. What's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong, Cobras? Hello? I feel so confused. I too am confused. What a water. Actually, we just got a Brita filter. Apparently, it should be fine with a Brita filter. We're in an area where apparently it would be fine with a Brita filter. If it gets worse, then we have to go into drinking bottled water. To be honest, our go-to is just have cheap freeway cola and orange juice, orangeade, and like fruit drinks and shit. Just have nice drinks. Nothing, I just play with my tools. Okay. Who designed the pipes? Pretty sure half of them are still fucking lead at this point. Come Scotland, our water is different. True. Freeway cola, that's Aldi. And it's also Lidl. Freeway cola in the UK is Aldi and Lidl. You can get it at both. Over here. I can smell food, I'm hungry, fuck's sake. That's why I get annoyed with my dad when he cooks when I'm streaming, because I want to know. Whiskey, the water of life. Those pipes are old. Well, my country was basically rooted in the Romans. We have roads. Our best roads in the UK were Roman built. That's saying something. Oh wait, right. Freeway cola is Lidl, Aldi, and River. Aldi's River's cola. See, that's what you get when you get stuff delivered now, instead of going to the store yourself. Construction peaked in 300 BC. Yeah, the fucking whole the whole Library of Alexandra burning down kind of fucked everyone. Technically speaking, it makes sense that at 300 BC the fucking... Wait, when did the fucking Library of Alexandra burn down? I know it set back humanity like 1,000 years.
It was that bad. Instead I have a good bottle of 12-year-old Bumir smoky whiskey. Tastes so good. Oh. I'm gonna get so drunk at TwitchCon. TwitchCon US, more specifically. TwitchCon EU, I'm gonna drink, but I'm gonna be chill. 48 BC by Julius Caesar. Yeah, so it makes sense, Seth. It makes sense. It makes fucking sense. It makes sense, doesn't it? Hey, if it didn't burn down, we wouldn't have you. If it didn't burn down, you would still have me, but you would have me as an actual real life cat girl, and like we would probably have flying cars, and Elon Musk probably wouldn't own like Twitter. Hi, the library never actually burned. I thought all the documents got burned, or a healthy portion of them burnt down. I don't know, I'm really shit with my history. I'm an internet waifu. That's kind of my go-to profession. When people ask me what my job is, I just turn around and say, I'm an anime waifu on the internet. That's like my best go-to. I'm an anime waifu on the internet. That is all I have. We should have had flying cars 10 years ago. Elon wouldn't have made Twitter into try-hard edgy platform. And the Hyperloop would be old tech by now. They were stored at a port with a bad paper. They just rotted. I thought Julius Caesar landed in the port and he started targeting the buildings and he thought, ah, this is a palace. We will burn down their palace. And he went to go burn it down and it turns out it was just a huge fucking library and it all burnt down. There's like depictions and artworks of it. Also, Roman concrete is perfect. Isn't there a trait with Roman concrete where like they used shells at the right gradient of like groundy stuff and it like repairs itself with water? They burn the city, not the library. Huh. So they burn the city. I don't know. It still set humanity back a fucking long time. Hyperloop? Elon Musk's Hyperloop is all you need to look. Just need to type up Hyperloop. She tells her, I'm gonna loosen my headset a little. It's not tight.
Let me let go.
Oh yeah, I learned. Do you want to know a cool thing? On my new phone, it has a piano, the band thing. I was fuck-assing around on it yesterday. I learned how to play fucking My Chemical Romance. I learned how to play My Chemical Romance by trial and fucking error. I literally learned how to play it by trial and error and just remembering how, like, key grading works. I went, that one, that one, that one, that one. I went, dun, 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 dun. And I was like, oh my fucking god. What the fuck?
Who knew my mostly useless deep dive into history finally became useful?
Yeah, I remember stupid shit. I have what's called pub quiz brain. I think that's what they call it over here. I have pub quiz brain. I remember stupid shit. Like the fact that Volkswagen's number one selling product isn't a fucking car. It's actually a sausage. Because in everywhere but the UK within Europe, when you buy a car, a Volkswagen from a dealership, you get a box of, you get like a reasonable size box of sausages from them and a pamphlet that lets you order sausages from Volkswagen. We don't get that in the UK or in the US.
Yeah, I got stuff to do because...
Okay, Sheena, have a wonderful day. I literally read that in my head, like how you say it.
I thought it was, oh my God. What, this one? What's wrong with my pose? I'm falling. What's wrong with my pose, huh?
Or do you want it so you can see?
I
Bingo, bingo. Oh fuck, I'm so happy I could figure that out. That was what that was as it happened. It would have freaked me the fuck out. Car, why are you blue screening? Did you just nut all over your keyboard? Don't do that. No gooning. No gooning. Heavy nut drop. It was supposed to be sticky key within the blue screen. I disabled sticky key. Do you guys disable sticky key when you do a computer? Like, one of the first things I fucking do is I go in and I disable so much shit like sticky key. I fucking hate that thing. Yes, the key would be sticky. Not like that! Oh my god. Yeah, I have pub quiz brain. I got pub quiz. Yeah. What key is me on phone? What phone you got? I haven't got games on my phone, by the way. I could technically get some games on there, actually. My brain really wants to get Life is Strange on my phone for, like, flights and stuff. Ah! Ooh! No, that would be dumb. I was literally thinking, oh, I could get the iPad and then give it to Nemo. And then say, you can play Life is Strange on this if you want, and then have her play Life is Strange on my iPad. But by the time we get to the end of the flight, she'll be fucking in tears and wanting to, like, kill something. I'm like, no, Nemo! Let me take care of you. I need to take care of you now. Katie thinking she's smart? Marmite and cheese sandwiches aren't that bad. Cheese and peanut butter is also okay. Nemo is currently away for the weekend. They're going away to celebrate a friend's birthday party because they just turned one of their friends turned 18. When you randomly find a catchy song on an Instagram recommended reel and it turns out to be a hella good song sung by someone who apparently starred in a hit series by the small name of Stranger Things, well then. The song that's stuck in my fucking head at the moment is Look My Way from Hell of a Boss. It's Look My Way. That's like the one that's stuck in my fucking head at the moment. I'm not watching the show and I'm like sitting there going, fuck. Nah, go hard, go home, Vegemite and cheese is the bomb. Okay, Kara, I want to say this now. We are both fucking wrong. What you want is pickles. What you want is pickles from a jar of pickles. What that is? It's like dark brown fucking pickle things from a jar. And, like, they're really, really, really nice with cheese. Like, you just sit there going, I don't think I'm gonna... Oh. I love this game. Still in her has-been hotel Hell of a Boss arc. I haven't watched Hell of a Boss. There's, like, 3 seasons or something of it, I think. Australian fans will have you know... You're indeed wrong, Vegemite on toast, nothing else. But I'm British, and I'm we prefer Marmite, because it's Vegemite but softer. That's the thing. If in the UK you either like Marmite or you hate Marmite, but not everyone. But Vegemite is very much a chosen flavor. I'm someone who can't have either because it's just yeast and from is like wheat, barley, and rye yeast. So they're nopes. So I can't have them, which sucks fucking ass because I used to love Marmite. I used to have Marmite on toast. It was so nice. It was great. I miss it. Yes, so you're wrong on all occasions, according to the Australians. That's the thing, though. Like, sorry. British True will try everything. Jake, the British are the reason why the dodo went fucking extinct. We ate them all. The reason why the Galapagos turtle is almost extinct is because the British fucking ate loads of them. I shit you not, Jake. We turned up in the Galapagos. We saw these slow-ass motherfuckers wandering around. And we just went, yeah, they look good. We picked them up and we put them on our boats and ate them out at sea. There is more fucking turtle carcasses in the oceans because of the British than there are on land. Do you understand that? I'll hide the turtles in Area 18 Arc Corp. British people, do they have a flag? We do. It's a white background with a red cross. And then we've got the Union Jack. We have technically got two. And then we got the Windsor flag, but no one pays attention to that because it's fucking pretentious. Did you see the picture of the king, by the way, that they revealed? It made me instantly think of Elden Ring and the fucking Scarlet Rot section, and I was like, God damn, that looks like a fucking terrifying boss. Like, it looks like a fucking concept.
Phoenix, Reborn DK asked me, hey Katie, you cute bean. Did you know that research shows that most women at one point in their life possess highly intelligent DNA? Unfortunately, most women will spit it out. Oh, how original. Another joke. On the internet, I'm sure you think you're very clever. If you wanted to impress Ms. KTB, you might want to try using those highly intelligent brain cells you were referring to. But then again, maybe that's too much to ask. Have fun with the stream.
I can't tell if you said that I'm stupid, and the only time I've ever been intelligent was when I had cum in my mouth. Is that the joke? Is the joke? Oh, you be at the only time a woman has been smart is when she has cum in her mouth. Or, but man, yeah, that's what I'm thinking. But I don't spit, I swallow. I don't spit, I swallow. So I used to still have that DNA inside me. Huh? I'm so confused. Didn't mean it to be the question one. Yeah, that happens. Instant karma. Is this really a cum eating joke? I think so. Damn, I can't believe Phoenix is so fucking sexist. Oh my god, we should cancel him. I should write my twit longer about how he was so sexist towards me. I'm joking, I won't do that. It's too much writing involved. I'm dyslexic. My dyslexia stops me from writing twit longers. I come, you come, they come. We all come for come. How are you doing, Kay? I'm doing good. I smell food and I'm getting fucking hungry. It fucking sucks. After my stream, I'm gonna go bath, but I know what my dad's like. He's probably gonna be like, oh, food's ready. I'm like, but I want a bath. He's like, no, you can go off the bath. Why do you insist on me not getting in the bath straight away? Let me have a bath and then we can fucking eat. No, you got food ready. I'm like, fuck you, dude. I got chili con carne for dinner. Ask your manager to run your social media platform too, Katie.
Dakota, I'm actually getting a new manager for that. I'm trying to get cuteness to do it. Or at least give me directions and figure out what I could post. Just give me ideas and then we can go through like photo shoots and stuff to do like weekly. And then plan out content, look at content, do this, do that. Rah, 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 rah. That's like my plan, by the way. I just have cuteness lurk my streams. I have cuteness lurk my streams. They're just coming out. Getting cuteness to do what? Interesting. I have a lot I'm trying to get cuteness to do, okay? I'm definitely gonna... We're watching SpongeBob together at TwitchCon. It's gonna be great. I just thought of something. Katie, what do you usually do on Fridays? On Fridays, I will do what I call a catch-up stream. I do a catch-up stream. Then, I do my catch-up stream. Then I do, I work out. I do what I need to, and then. So if Neil is your manager and cuteness is your social media manager, what will I be? Dakota. Hi, Dakota. You're my birthday buddy. No. You just need to find that bed. Yeah. So no time that often. Sad Phoenix noises. Well, it depends, really. After my stream, I can be really, really busy, or I can be very not busy. I want to try and be more social, but it's kind of difficult for me to do that. Should we put cuteness at hammock? Should we buy cuteness a hammock? No. At TwitchCon, we're planning to cuddle up on the sofa and watch SpongeBob in the morning. Our plan is to wake up first and then go and Dakota, what the fuck are you doing? Why are you being a fucking gremlin? Who is this? I don't know who that is. I thought it was Nags for a second. It looks like Nags. It's not Nags. I know a swing. Sex swing? I drank water. Yeah, you drank water! Congratulations! My friend Chris. Ow. Oh god, my fucking headset is itching my head now. I need to clean this fucking gasket. Love me like you do. Love me like you do. I still need to go eat! Okay, I'm afraid for the future. I'm 17 in grade 11 and I don't know. I'm gonna make a living and move out with my parents. Any advice? Okay. When it comes to, okay, consider this, hon. The world is fucked. When it comes to you trying to get your own place, it's going to be extremely difficult. I'm 31 years old, and I've been trying to move out for a couple of years now. In terms of what can you do for a living, I would say this. Do you just want money? Or do you not care about money, and would you rather do what you want for a living? Because I'm the type of person that doesn't give two shits about money. I mean, I care about making enough to cover my bills. I've grown to a point now where I'm more conscious of trying to make more money. I'm trying to build a future for myself rather than just sit still. I'm tired of sitting still. And I've always been someone to just do what I love and just go about it that way. In terms of just trying to make a living, talk to your parents. If you live with your parents and they're loving and they're caring and they don't mind you staying there and they don't care about you staying there and so on and so forth, ask them for a window of, say, a year to find yourself a job. So that's like my advice. Ask them for a year to try and give you grounds to find yourself and try and find yourself a job. Just go for any job. Ask your parents how much the rent will cost, and then just try and keep on top of your rent. Try and keep on top of your bills. Always put your expenditure first. So bills, like that much for electricity, this much for the internet, this much for rent, blah, 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 blah. Don't feel like you need to rush to try and move out. The world is fucked right now. If you're in the UK, the US, Australia, I think the only country right now that isn't fucked in terms of housing is probably Japan. Because they've got such an old house problem. It's a completely different issue over there. I know Australia's fucked for housing as well, though probably not to the same degree. But yeah. The trades are always a solid choice. Yeah, the trades are also a solid choice. I recommend you learn how to do accounting. It's always a good backup career, and it's useful for you as well. I would rather be happy, but yeah, first thing I want to do is make a livable wage. I mean, I don't want to talk about my money. I don't want to really talk about my income, but I make more now than I did 6 months ago. My income increases roughly every 6 months or so it's really, really different for me. What I was making 6 months ago is what I was making 6 months ago was way more than what I was making 6 months before that, and what I was making 6 months before that was more than that. I'm at a point now where I'm making enough so I can start treating myself and go on big trips. I've already made more this year so far in the last 5 months than I did all of last year. That's how much money I've made so far this year. My income has jumped up quite a lot. Thanks to you guys, and I honestly can never thank you fuckers enough. Even the asshats that keep calling me fucking cute. Because I'm not. But no, I'm a firm believer in doing what you love for a living. Because at the end of the day, you only get one playthrough. You don't get to hit save and restart. You only get one playthrough. Don't make regrets. But do what you love for a living. Don't feel the pressure. I live in Canada. You're in a weird, icky spot where it's like you've got the fucking housing crisis, shit internet, and like other bullcrap going on because of politics. But then the world's got politics problems. But yeah, when it comes down to it, hon, the only suggestion I can really do with you is say,
you're cute.
I'm not cute. Figure out what you want to do. Figure out what you love for a living, and don't think about anything else. That's the thing. Just figure out what you want to do. If you do what you love for a living, money will come. Thing or thong? No, I'm wearing a thong. I was saying thing. Gah. Well, I only have one thong to say about that. If you love cars, don't become a mechanic. Oh god, yeah. If you love cars, don't become a mechanic. What you want to... If you love cars, instead of becoming a mechanic, become a car dealer. It's way more enjoyable. Mechanics, you learn to hate cars. When you sell them, you love them. Nippy, I'm all a fluss now. Why are you a fluster? You're a great investment, Katie. Worth every penny. I'm actually not gonna lie. I did the calculations for me moving, for me doing TwitchCon, and I said to myself, it's gonna take me about 4 or 5 months to save up. It took me 6 weeks. It took me 6 weeks to save up for both fucking TwitchCons. That's how fucking insane it's been this year. I originally thought I was gonna take me like 4 or 5 months. No. I really want to make sure some kind of art thing, whether it be a web novel or a game, music making, or getting good at art. I really want to love that, you know, because art is so cool. Then find yourself a job and then do art as a hobby. In terms of art as a career, it takes quite a lot of dedication. And by the way, as someone who works in the games industry for like 5 years, I'm going to tell you this now. Most artists will not hit their career stride until they hit 30. That's like a really harsh, the real biggest harsh reality check when it comes to being an artist is this. You will not hit your career stride until you hit 30. There is a point where, as a creative person, you hit 30 years old, and then suddenly, within an 18-month window of you turning 30, could be before or after, within a year and a half, before or after you turn 30, you'll have a moment and you'll go, oh, and then suddenly everything starts moving forward, everything starts making sense, everything starts, you start getting into the rhythm and it starts going good. And then you'll be puttering along and then, whoa, suddenly things start picking up. That's kind of what's happened with me. I turned 30, God, I turned 30 a while ago now, fuck. Five months until I turned 32, 12. Five, seven, yeah. So I recently started hitting my stride. I started to make movement. I started to get into it. It's a point. You just hit a point and it just starts to make sense. Don't worry about the future. Don't worry about your future. Just enjoy the present. A friend in that field, he now makes really good money, but it was a lot of hard work. Yeah, there's a reason why I say a lot of artists don't hit their stride until they're 30, and it's because there's just a point where it just suddenly it starts making sense. It's like when it comes to working out, you can do a workout wrong and then you force yourself to do it right, and then eventually you're at a point where you're not thinking about it and you're doing it right, and then suddenly everything starts working. You're like, oh, huh, so suddenly I can start doing those exercises without much problem. It's like you go to the gym and you do a workout, like you're struggling to do a basic squat, and then you're doing squats and you're struggling to do squats, and then you learn your form is wrong, so you focus on trying to get your form good, and then you're doing really 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 good form squats. And suddenly the squats become really, really fucking easy, but the reason why they're becoming easier is because you focused on one thing and you weren't paying attention to the other thing, and then that became easier. So then you add more weight, and then you're like, ah, this is starting to be really good. And then, like, you go from, like, 20-pound weights, say, you go from, like, doing 20-kilogram squats with it, and then that becomes super easy, so then you jump up to 40 kilograms, and then you're struggling with that, and then suddenly that becomes easy. It's like overnight it goes, suddenly it's easy. 30 is when you really start getting into your stride. Yeah. It's where you start getting into your stride with any and everything. Just don't worry about it and have fun with it. Life is not all about work. It's not all about career. It's about living. Learn to live. Take risks. Have fun. Hello, Spring Freddy. How are you doing today? I'm probably the worst person to get life advice from, to be honest. I'm very much someone who I feel like I'd never really. I've not had a normal life. I'm probably gonna have to write a mem. Am I gonna have to write a memoir at some point? I've not lived a normal life, at least non-conventional. I would take a step. Yeah, I've had a non-conventional life. I'm probably the worst person to take advice from. I'm gonna get more orange juice. You got your orange juice. Big orange juice. Big, 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 big orange juice. Orange juice. Gotta get the rough mix of work and play as essential. Yeah! all work and no play and all that lot. Well, no, that's the thing. It's not about that. It's... if you live for your job, you're a career. If you live for your job, then it's just a career. Then you don't... It's the whole thing of... Give me a second. It's the whole thing with rich people. It's... So consider this. This is probably the most hardest fact you've probably never really gotten into your head at some point. Successful people fail at other aspects of life. Someone who is really, 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 really good at being a business person is probably a sociopath who's probably abandoned their family, abandoned their friends, and has no social life outside their social life. Someone who's got a really lovely social life probably has a really, really shit career going on. Someone who's really, really good at one thing usually has many aspects in their life they're shit at. Like me, I've kind of dedicated my life at this point to being hopefully a good content creator. I hope I am. Or at least a good streamer. I try to be a good streamer. I learned to try and be a good streamer. But like... I've dedicated it to it. Guess what? My real world social life is non-fucking-existent. It's non-existent. Because I've dedicated myself to trying to be a good content creator for you guys. And I constantly strive to do it. But I still have friends. I just don't have real world friends. Because I just don't... I've always been someone who's okay being on their own. My mum joked with me when I was younger, saying if you don't go out, you're going to grow up to be a recluse. And then, like, I'm 31. I'm pretty much a recluse at this point, and I'm okay with that. Are you kidding me? My tracking is doing the fucking ass slide thing again. Oh, I like being alone too. My friends won't let me though. Just enjoy life. Do what you love and just enjoy life. Fuck it. I want a bird. What bird you want? Hi, Toxie. Hi. How are you doing? Welcome into the stream. I keep seeing drips. This way. Yeah, there's drips from outside. It's like a gap. Hi. Shoebill stalk. I don't think those can be pets, hun. I don't think that those can be pets. Whatever it is, I'm sorry. Bud in British could mean girl, no. If you're part of a toxic friendship, yeah? Or from Landen? Yeah. I will try. I said a thing a minute ago that I want you to see. Patrick Maitman, I feel like I got no momentum, you know, like I'm stagnant. How old are you again? One second. How old are you again? You're 17. Bitch, you're fucking 17. You've got no worry about that. Okay, here's the thing. You're 17. When I was 17, I wasn't thinking, yo, what's my fucking career gonna be like? It's, yo, this girl I'm trying... Actually, no. When I was 17, I came out. My whole point... I came out as being trans at 17. My whole brain was going, holy shit. Am I going to look good as a fucking female? Oh my god, what if I look fucking ugly? Oh my god, how do you put makeup on? How do you do makeup? What underwear do I wear with what thing? How do skirts work? It's fine. You're 17. You shouldn't have momentum until you're at least 23, if I'm honest. Gonna say this. Between now until your prefrontal cortex is yet to kick in, until you have a blinding moment of clarity, you're allowed to not worry about your momentum. You're gonna have a moment in the next 5 to 7 years. You're gonna literally have a moment in the next 5 to 8 years where your prefrontal cortex is just gonna kick in and you're just gonna go, oh, I get it. And then you're just gonna get on with things. At 17, you shouldn't have to worry about anything. You're gonna be fine. My mum is a Christian who watches Matt Walsh, so God knows if I'm not coming out till I move out. Yeah, I've only ever had problematic things around religious family members. By the way, the best thing to do, best thing if you are trans and you come out to your parents and they turn around and said, but God made you as you are, you should be happy with how God made you. Your response will be, yeah, so why do you have a problem with it? You just turn around and say, God made me this way, what the fuck are you talking about? I'm like, but God made you this way, you should be happy with your body. I'm like, I'm trying to be. That's the whole reason why I'm trans! Use what they say against them. If they pull an argument, you use that argument against them. If they say, God made you that way, just turn around and say, yeah, and that's why I'm living this way. Why is that a problem? And it just works. It works almost every time. Think that would work with drugs too. Hi, Jake. Hi. Yeah, at 17, you're worries. Oh my god, I don't know what I'm doing in my future. Don't worry about it. Between the ages of 13 and 21 of yourself of having under reconstruction written on your forehead as your brain does a lot of changes. Yeah. And at the age of between the ages of 20 and 24 years old, your prefrontal cortex, your danger part, the part in your brain that says danger, don't do this stupid thing, consideration isn't a thing. If you're empathetic before the age of like 20, you've had really good mental development. When I say good mental development, I mean really good mental development. There is just a point. Everyone in this chat will agree. There is a moment mentally where it just slaps you and you go, oh, and I call it the blinding moment of clarity where everything falls into line for you. It's all the dots converging. And that's a point. It's like an epiphany. And it'll just slap you out of nowhere. And everyone in chat will say this. They've had that moment. Everyone in the chat, at least over the age of, say, 25, I want to say. They've had that moment. Yes, a few times. Sometimes it happens a couple times. I've had it 3 times. Mine was when I lost my, one of my closest friends growing up. Another one was when I was, first time it was when I was 11 years old. Second time was when I lost one of my friends. No, second time was when I learned to become very appreciative. When I was 11 years old, it was when I lost my granddad. My mum's dad. 11, 12 years old. I lost my granddad and I just came to terms with, finally, with loss. And how this is a normal part of life and it's something that everyone treats it differently. It just hit me in a weird way and I just kind of changed from it. The other one was when I left school and I learned to appreciate what I had and just appreciate those memories, and it's just a blinding moment. And the other one was when I was with the psycho ass bitch that lived here and I went, I should not allow toxic people in my life. Like, toxic people aren't worth your time. Fuck them. Just get rid of them all. If it's your family members, fuck them. Selected family is way better than forced family. I had that, but as a dude, I still do stupid stuff knowing it is stupid. True. Yes, a few times. When what's supposed to happen. There is a moment in your life where there's just this blinding moment of clarity where things just, where you just go, oh shit. And you just, it's like a moment of realization. I call it the blinding moment of clarity. Your prefrontal cortex just kicking in, just being like, ah, we've got connections going here. You're like, ah, oh, fuck.
I'm just sick of stagnating in my bed or my phone day after day, barely trudging through my day at school. I want to finally be able to do shit on my own. Pyro, do you want to know what's a really, really interesting fact that I learned? At Harvard University, right, it is a common thought that it is easier to start your own work than it is to find work. Why don't you give yourself a big project, a game project? Learn game development. Watch pirate software games. Listen to his clips. Do all of that stuff. Learn to make video games. Not only that, learn to make shitty video games and learn from them. Get feedback and then improve them and then move forward with them. Just have fun with it. You wanna do something artistic and creative? Learn basic bitch game development. Get yourself like Game Maker or Unreal or Unity and put a ball in a maze and make it so if you touch the sides of the walls, you go nope. And then you have to start again, and your goal is to get from through the maze and get to the green, to get to the cherry or something at the end. Something simple. Make a simple ass game. Start simple, work it out. And what you do is you go, well, now we got the cherry. What are we going to do with the cherry? Let's make it so the cherry gives you a power up. Yo, that's another improvement. Game 2.0. We're going to take the original and we're improving it. Let's go. You know, shit like that. Start small, work up. Start doing. And there is procrastination. There's also this point as well. There's a point where you procrastinate endlessly. And there's a point in your life where you go, I'm done procrastinating. I'm getting on with it. You're in the procrastination phase. Just start trying to get on with it. I don't remember having one of those yet. It will happen. I turned 24 this year. I'm pretty sure you have. It's just yours is probably different. Everyone has them differently. Mine is very much just big moments of me going, oh fuck. Also, it could be the tism, son. It could, the tisms make it way different. It might not happen for another couple years. I agree, Katie. Pirate has great video advice. Yeah. When the reality you have shatters into 1,000 shards. Yeah, it's like this blinding moment. It's like the realization that the relationship you're in is toxic and you should leave. It's the realization that, oh fuck, I'm massively overweight. I should start taking care of myself because I'm not going to be around in 5 to 10 years time if I keep going the way I'm going. It's kind of one of my more recent moments of going, oh fuck, I should start taking care of myself more. I kind of want to get my weight to my goal and then start working on my voice. The next couple years here is going to be interesting. You're going to want to be around for it. You should subscribe. The stream is freezing every 2 seconds right now. For me, I got no idea what is going on. It's showing it's fine for me. Like on all accounts, it's like green, 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 green. Either try reloading the page or try to refresh your cookies on Twitch. Age does not equal experience. Yeah. Working up to open world survival game where magic allows for evolution of to. Yeah. Go for it. Pyro, start small, work up. Join my Discord. I've got sections in there, which is just the creators corner. Go into the creators corner. Talk about your project in there. Show them print screens. Show them your works in progress. Encourage people. Encourage people to just. Obviously, we have a thing. If you are trying to make a game, don't fucking DM it to people saying, "Hey, can you test this game for me?" Because there's a problem with Discord where that happens all the time. Show people your work in progress. Show people this. Show people that. Show them a demo. See how it goes. Just go about it that way. Get people interested in it. Just have fun with it. Making video games is fucking great. I can make a quick Pokemon style game in like a couple of hours, actually. I used to be able to. It's been a while. Then becomes a reborn moment. Make sure you don't have the video set to auto. Oh yeah, that as well.
My Twitch is starting to act up too. It could be me. I'm starting to see occasional little blippies. It could be my bitrate. My bitrate appears to be hovering at the 6.6k. It could be a Twitch side problem or a me side problem. Or it's my stream. Where's my analytics? I got rid of the panel. Fuck. Stats. Ow. Yeah, I'm apparently getting some dropped frames every now and then. I will keep this up. Thank you for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Not you. My app is being weird. Okay. So we got my Pokemon. Here's my Pokemon. I have a whole ass Google Doc on my ideas for making Pokemon better. Pyro, put them into practice. Do your own version. I'm really tempted to actually look at doing the 2.5D game that I did in college. I'm gonna close this. Don't think I need it. Seems to be fine. The stream is relaxed. This stream is relaxing. Yeah, apparently that's a common thing that people say here, Dev. Is that, am I right in saying that, Jake? You've been here long enough. I like to talk. I just like to yap. I'm a yap streamer. I'm a YouTuber as well. I'm a yap streamer. I yap a lot. There's a reason why the fucking schedule for Friday, Saturday, Sunday is yap and then Monday is gaming. Yap is laid back. Yeah. Yeah, Dick's kind of like hardcore into stream saying here. Thank you for the clipping, by the way. I need to go through them. Whoa. What? We don't say the ass word here. Unless they're into it. I feel good. I like it. I'm wondering if we could hit the goal this weekend. Should I give you guys... Wait, 1 second. We have one more weekend. Should I give you guys a reward? Should I figure out a reward if we hit the sub goal this weekend? Should we come up with an idea for if we hit the goal this weekend? Huh? Does that sound fun? Because you're not far off of it. You're only like 49 subs away from the goal. You ever read web novels and magic feels? Has unlimited possibilities to build yourself up. I want my game to feel like that. A fantasy web novel, I mean. So I had an idea a while ago to do a video game based on the idea of a crafting system. But the idea was, you would do things where... The idea I had was you had different types of magic. You had elemental magic, you have luminosity magic, you had luminosity magic, astrology magic, and dark magics. Luminosity magic basically would be light and dark. Astrology magic would be like the utilizing like beyond stuff. I had this idea to do a really, really, really cool magic system, right? And the whole concept behind it was this. You build your spells so you would have a codex. So you would have had a grimoire, right? The whole concept behind my game was this. You would have a grimoire and you could write your spells in there. So you would form your spells, right? And depending on your level, depends on the high levels of success. But the whole point was this. You would form it, so you would have like a fire one would have a certain type of circle, and then the form in its shape would cause it to have a different circle with different lines flowing through it. And then the whole point would be is you would formulate these casting circles per spell. but it gave you so much potential. So you could do, so the basic rock spell would be a rock spell that you can just summon. So the character would hold up a hand and then they'd summon a stone, and the stone would be small, quite small, and then it wouldn't have any projection. It would just fall to the floor. Yeah, so it would be like that. So what you would do is you go, well, what would be the next step? What am I doing wrong? Why can't this attack? It's because you've got to add speed and direction to it. So you would go speed and direction forward and put as much speed into it as you want. It goes really, really, really far, but the accuracy goes out of the window. But if you put more into direction, the accuracy goes up, but the speed goes down. Make sense? So you go rock, speed, direction, and it goes forward. But then it's got no form, so then you add form to it and you make it into a cone. And then you add a cone to it and then suddenly it goes really, really, really far and it hits the target. But that's just one of them. So what you do is you add more of them. So then you go, and it goes, and it goes. And that was the whole point. You would make a magical system around doing that type of shit. And it'd be like, that'll be the whole idea. So we do it, work out for water, work out for this, work out for that, all this, all that. And then like you could start combining them as well. So you could do fire and earth magic to do like a lava thing. So you could do like an earth wave. You could do like earth wave mixed with fire, and it would cause a lava wave to happen. That was like the whole point I had. And I looked into it, and it was like, I could do it, but it's so hard and so complicated. It's like, ugh. Hi, Oliver. Hi. And I got cut into pieces again in MG34. Why did that happen? Huh? What did you do? So this might sound dark, but what about water and earth just to form blood magic? Water and earth? I won't do water. Fuck you. Fuck you, cuteness! Cuteness, I have an idea, by the way. Cuteness, I have an idea. I'm gonna run it past you after stream, okay? I'm not gonna fucking lie. I think you'll like it. I told you I was touching. That was fucking adorable. Fuck you, no it wasn't. No, it fucking wasn't. Me too have ideas. Oh god. No, I have an idea for cuteness. It'll be beneficial for them and it'll be technically beneficial for me. Fuck was that? Evil Maxwell. Thank you for the biddies! But yeah, cuteness, I have an idea for you. I'll run it past you after stream. Hello? Hello? Hi. What? By the way, you know that McDougal's cat? McDougal's? Oh my god, they... Fuck's sake! Oh my god, the pop pin from below the frame, the sniff. Fuck you! Almost don't wanna save you a load of money now. Fuck's sake. Did you lose chat? Stop! What are you doing?
Hello. The world is all sunshine and rainbows. Cutus, did you just discover Tangia? Is it because I put hash? Is it because I put exclamation point? The fuck is this? Oh, that's not what I wanna say. Oh my god, I'm 41 out of 100 to get on the part of the plush eligibility. What the fuck? Yes. Oh my god. Is it because I put the exclamation point thing in my title? Okay. So currently I just have a Windows 7 laptop, my phone, and my tablet. You're on Windows 7 still? I'm gonna say this. You can do it. Trust me. Unreal Engine, you could do Unreal Engine, you could do Game Maker Studio. Now we know what you are like with new toys, dot dot dot. Oh, no. Completely different.
Are you open?
Apparently.
I'll have a Krabby Patty Deluxe and a double chili kelp fries.
That'll be $7.95. Okay. Or is that for the other stream? Maybe for the other stream. Thank you for all the biddies, Curtis. You have to do this. You should really stop, actually, because it's a lot of money. For me, not for you. I made a funny. My laptop broke and my dad is too busy with odd jobs and looking for a place
George,
to move.
Don't touch.
I'm touch! The fuck? I should really tell the bot thing to ignore the Tangia bot. With odd jobs and looking for a place to move out to look into fixing the laptop. Considering it's Windows 7, it might be actually worth looking into getting a new laptop. Might I suggest building a PC?
Oh, look at him joke! Look at him suffer!
Well, fuck you then! Why are you being mean to me, bitch? Fuck you! The fuck are you doing? Fuck you! Why do you keep doing that? I'm just trying to jam out! Oh my god! The fuck are you doing? Holy fuck! Mean to me. You got hide in the bye bye. Go to bully the cute. No, I'm not cute. Fucking cuteness and Kara. Stop. No hype train. What are you doing? I said no hype train. What
the fuck are you guys doing? No two hype train stream. Bad. Bad. Stop. Fuck off. No. No one subscribed. Oh, no little biddies. No one. No more people. Cute. No, I'm not. Fuck off. Shut up. Not cute. Oh my god. No fucking hype train. Stop it. Bitch. Ah. What are you doing? What are you doing? Why? Why does he keep going?
Oh my god.
Harris, why? Why? I don't even know what reward I want to give you for the fucking... if you hit this weekend. My current working laptop is satellite of Windows 7 and my last laptop broke. Won't turn on was my Windows 7. And I probably could look into maybe learning how to make a PC tower PC. We have quite a few PC tower corpses laying around. Oh, Linus Tech Tips. Linus Tech Tips will probably be the best option you've got, Pyro. Linus Tech Tips has a massive comprehensive guide on how to build a PC. They've actually got like 3 of them at this point. Well worth looking into. Wow, we're fucking into. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Wah, 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 wah.
Now look, Buster. Let's have an understanding.
Oh, not this one again!
Brother, what a way to run a railroad. Now, as I was saying...
Hello. Hello. I hate that one. It's so over the top. It was actually horrible. I need to make some of the bigger ones more fucking expensive. Thank you for all the billies and thank you for all the subs. I really love and appreciate you guys. Hi, Lex. Yeah. I got some, I got orange juice. Hi, hi. Oh god. I'm getting there. I don't feel safe drinking the water. We have apparently got a poop water problem. Welcome back to Carter. Oh. 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 Shut up. Why the fuck would you send that one? I hate that one. It's creepy. It's weird when I'm standing back here alone like this, and then someone puts it on my butt. R2, where do you keep going? He keeps disappearing. Where does he keep going off to? I'm concerned. I'm concerned about his mental safety and mental health. Did you ever find a charger? Oh yeah, my charger comes tomorrow. He's looking for cake. Huh. Wait, Tunis, are you in VR? Is that why you keep poking me? Because you want me to hang out with you after or some shit?
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time cards.
No, okay. Do you want to hang out and call? After stream? Huh? Huh? Are you joking? Why the fuck are you making the hype train go bigger? What the fuck, guys? I wanted to go get food. I'm fucking hungry.
Right, yeah, I should turn off the edit mode. I'm still debating what to eat myself. Well, don't eat yourself. Don't eat yourself. That's like a really, really bad idea. I heard that's how you can die. Salad, nice cake, I don't know. I'm pescatarian, I know you're vegetarians, so it's kind of awkward. Hello! Eat cake. Eat cake, it's your sweet snack. Such eyes. I done now. Thank you for the biddies! I really love and appreciate it! Now no fucking more subs or bits, because I want the hype train to go bye-bye. We need the hype train to stop, okay? No more! No more! No more. I love and appreciate you, but no more. Okay? No more. I'm not cute. Shut up. I don't know. Okay. I go eat now.
That shit. Tomato booger. Garbage. Nightmare. Bad. Bad. Tomato bad. Tomato loser girl. Bad.
What the fuck did I do this time? Huh? Stop telling people to stop giving you love. I told them to stop. I told them to stop. I told them to stop. I didn't tell you not to carry on. Stop telling people to stop giving you love. Oh, right. Yeah, I read that. But I want the hype train to go away. I don't want it to stay here anymore. So stop means go. No, stop means stop. It means no more gifting subs. No more biddies. Following's okay. No donating. No more nothing, okay? No more. No more. Okay? Or stop. No, it means stop. It means stop. I'm hungry. And I don't wanna end my stream partway into a fucking hype train. It'll look bad on me. I don't want that. Okay, he wants donations. Alright, let me look at my bank account. People leave. No, I don't want you to donate either. ERP. Later. If you're a good girl. Oh, fuck is... Hello? Hello? What the fuck was that? Hi, Monk! Hi! Ah! How are you? Sorry, I clicked the thing. Hi. How was your week? We forgot to watch Dune. But it's okay. I was kind of busy. I know you're heading off soon. Yeah. I wanna eat. I'm hungry. My feet hurt from standing up for like 3 hours. And I got a dodgy ankle because of fucking blisters. Love you so much. Thank you for being in my life. Aww. I'm gonna message you after the stream. I'm gonna threaten you with good times, I swear to fuck. Ooh, I got it. Ooh. Also, my tracking is starting to go. Oh my fucking god! I love that emote! That is such a cool emote. Working, yeah. Mm-hmm. To be exact, it looked like a snow grouse. Thank you for the information. R.I.P. Snow grouse. Anyway, I want to say thank you to all of y'all, because I really love and appreciate you all. Like, you have no idea how much I love and appreciate you all. I genuinely can't thank you all enough. Rip, I've got none. Should have resubbed then. I am going to. Is it doing it? I'm gonna throw you guys over to Sheena. They seem to be playing a game where they just run around in snow. I don't know what it is. Rise of the Tomb Raider? Yeah, they're playing like a game. I don't know. Go show Sheena all the love you can. Be careful with her though. If you watch her too much, when she types in the chat sometimes, you will start hearing it in her voice. It is a curse. There's a blessing and a curse, because you know it's her. But anyway, I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your night. Thank you everyone for such an amazing day. Thank you for all the subs. Thank you for all the bits. Thank you everyone who followed. I really, really, really do love and appreciate you all for all the support you give me. I can't thank you all enough. Have a wonderful rest of your day. I will see you guys tomorrow. Same time, same place. Join the Discord. I'm not fucking cute. I will bite you. Don't start. But yeah. Go show Sheena all the love you can. I will be back tomorrow at the same place and same time. I love you all so very fucking much. And I genuinely can't thank you enough. Go show Sheena all the love you can. I want to see a sea of follows. And I really, really would love and appreciate it if you could just show her some love, okay? I'll see you tomorrow, okay, guys? Bye! Also, Ivy, hi! Bye! Sorry for leaving at this time. My feet hurt. Bye, guys! I love you! Mwah. Bye, guys!